We go to West Plains, Randall comes here, and we go to Canyon. Those last three, I mean, we need to be in reasonably good shape going into those.
Yep. You know, it's to have all three Canyon schools back-to-back-to-back, which everybody basically has to do that. And it's a rough old stretch, I'm telling you. So you're exactly right. We need to win all these towns that are a lot like Hereford. Borger, Pampa, Harrington took care of. Dumas we'll need to take care of next week, too. So hopefully we can take care of business. They've got a Borger's got a shooter.
Yep.
That Borger, we'll certainly have to watch out for.
Borger's played well at times.
They beat
West Plains. No, Pampa beat West Plains.
Pampa did, yes.
I think Borger beat Pampa is what I actually think happened the first time around. So the Whiteface is here tonight, 17-12 on the year, 5-3 in district play, and warming up against these Lady Bulldogs at this very moment. Whiteface has won the JV a moment ago pretty decisively, so we'll take a 60-second break. Be back here at the Whiteface Gym in 1 minute.
Since 1901, the Hereford brand has been keeping readers informed and entertained with all things Hereford. A weekly historical column, detailed recaps of city and county government meetings, and photos of your favorite herd athlete or youngster fishing in the pond. Things have changed some since the early days, like being able to get the paper sent straight to your email. But some things have stayed the same, like providing local content you need to read. The Hereford brand, back in downtown Hereford, across from the courthouse.
Oh, there's nothing like the sound of a new baby calf or the smell of fresh rain on a cotton crop. My friends at Capital Farm Credit share this excitement with agricultural and livestock producers. We want to be your lending partner. Whether you require operating funds for next year's crop or need to buy hay for your cattle, we have a loan that's right for you. Let us finance your operation. CapitalFarmCredit.com.
Righty, back here at Whiteface Gym, the Lady Whitefaces and Borger continuing to warm up. Here's the standings in the district. It's pretty much the same in the boys. Canyon's 8-0, Randall's 7-1 in the girls. And then there's four of us, Hereford, West Plains, Pampa, and Borger. We're 5-3. West Plains is 4-4. Pampa's 4-4. Borger's 3-5. Out of those four teams, two are going to make the playoffs and two aren't.
Yeah, it could be one of those kinds of messes at the end of the district season where you could have perhaps a playoff for a seeding spot, or you could have a playoff for a playoff spot.
Yeah.
You know, and a little mini tournament, and so who knows? Our job is just to take care of business.
Yep.
And make sure we're one of those, and hopefully one of those headed to playoffs. And as a third-place team, it'd sure be nice to be there.
Yep. Well, and I'll tell you, if Borger's in a must-win situation here tonight, if they lose and go to 3-6, it's going to be hard for them to get back into that. But if they win, they're 4-5. We would be 5-4, and West Plains and Pampa are both 4-4. So it could be a virtual dead heat in this thing. So, man, we need to win. That's all there is to it.
Yep, and when we were up at Borger, tell you what, number five, Briscoe, she had a great first half against us. She was their shooter and was hitting everything. Then the second half, I mean, we really pushed hard, started guarding her a little bit better. Second half, they started working it into Loftus, and that's Coach Loftus's niece. And
well, that's not
started
right.
Working it into her, and she is a big, strong post kid underneath that got up and made several buckets, but we also fouled her quite a bit as well.
Well, the Whitefaces, we've had some good games. Like, we played well, with the exception, honestly, of just a couple of times. At the Pampa game, it's long gone, but that one really hurt us, losing to Pampa here at home. And Bartlett for Pampa, she's really a great player, and she just kind of wore us out when we played here the first time. So we'll see what tonight brings. I'm trying to think. I don't know if I know who else is playing this evening in the district, but whoever it is, their games are pretty important. Let's take a break here for 60 seconds. Brenda and I'll be back courtside 1 minute.
Start here, AC. Go anywhere. Amarillo College is the place to prepare. AC.
I wanted to be a nurse for years. Amarillo College helped me get there. I had a job lined up even before I graduated. With my degree from AC, I can go anywhere and do anything.
Trust your future to a college that cares. Start here, AC. Go anywhere.
Your business, farm and ranch, or home is unique, and success depends in part on a cost-effective and convenient supply of quality fuel. When you trust your fueling needs to Gooden Fuels, it's one less detail for you to manage. Commercial fuel in bulk in below-ground or above-ground tanks, serving the Western Panhandle with gasoline, diesel, and propane. Gooden Fuels in Hereford, 364-3366.
All righty, back here at Whiteface Gym. Anastasia and Adam back behind us. I talked to Anastasia a little bit ago, and she's feeling better, thank goodness.
Good,
so
good.
Good to have her back here amongst us tonight. And the Whitefaces continue to warm up here to our left. Aubrey Devon back now for this will be the third game since she was had the concussion. And, man, she made a difference, 14 points for her on Tuesday night up at Perryton, were really, really important.
Yeah, she led the Lady Whitefaces, and her three-point shooting can really open some things up for the ladies. And then she plays some awful good defense, too.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, coach is certainly not afraid to put her on the shooter, and I'll be curious to see if that's what she, if she plays on Briscoe tonight.
Well, we are just a couple of minutes away from start time, maybe 4 minutes or so. The officials are out. Pretty good crowd, but plenty of time for you to come on out and catch the girls' action and the boys tonight as the Whitefaces are at home, and the music is really rocking here. You'll want to get out while you can listen to, I don't know what it is, but you can listen to it just like we do. Coach Kitten's really into it. This is one of her favorites right here. What do you think, Coach? Boys and girls, how do you feel about tonight?
Well, I think we just need to come play a solid game on both ends of the court. We need to come out here and this little junk that we've kind of been a little unhappy about, oh, we don't play good at home.
Yeah.
We need to get over that, you know? That's what I think. And just get out here and play hard. Know that when you leave, know that you've just played hard. I think the win will take care of itself if we get out here.
Yeah.
I think the guys, I mean, they have been just playing their guts out late. I'm telling you, there's times I don't know how they make it through some of their games.
Yeah.
As tough it is as it is, and as fast as they go, it is just a harried pace that they play the entire game. It was nice to get a win up at Perryton for
it
those
really
guys.
Really was. Got behind in that game 14-0 and came back to win it by 7. Again, I seriously doubt. I mean, looking at him the other night, I don't know when Kenyon, what the return date is for him. There was talk he might try to play tonight, but gosh, he's lost 15 pounds or so, it looks like, and it's going to be really, really hard for him to get back in the swing of things, in at least for another, I'd say, week or two. It's just something that he's got to battle through, but it's not something you can battle through but just by getting out there and playing at some frantic pace for 32 minutes either. So
I'm sure coming to the game like you did on Tuesday night, sure that kind of wears you out. It kind of wears a person who hadn't been ill out going to Perryton and back on a on a school night. But
old people, it wears old people
yes,
out too.
Indeed,
I can testify.
It does. So hopefully he is on the mend and doesn't have any setbacks, and we can get him back in here.
Evening, refs are out. Whitefaces and Coach Taylor talking with the officials right now. Coach Ivy of the Lady Bulldogs gathering his crew up over here. We'll have the national anthem, the introduction of the players, and we'll get to play here tonight. Excuse me, I've got the sneezes here. The Bulldogs, again, 4-5 in the district, so or 3-5 in the district, so they are trailing the Whitefaces. Evening, sirs. The officials, two of them I'm not familiar with. One I am. He's been calling for just, oh, I don't know, 40 years or so, something like that. Quite a while. We're going to have the playing of the National Anthem, as I said, here in just a moment. And then the Lady Whitefaces and Lady Bulldogs will be introduced. And we'll play some basketball here tonight at Whiteface Gym. Glad you could join us. KPAN will be broadcasting the Dallas Cowboy-San Francisco game on Sunday. It seems to be of some importance if you like professional football. A big weekend with four great football games. Whiteface is in the white here tonight. Borger wearing black with the red trim. Two teams will circle up out at midcourt.
Welcome
and
to Hereford
Claudia
Gymnasium.
Will do
the
For generations, First Bank Southwest has been there to help the working hands that have shaped this great land. Chances are we helped your father, and even his father. We understand for some a handshake is a stronger bond than a piece of paper. And even though times can be tough, folks around here are tougher. And that's why we're as proud of our Panhandle roots as you are. First Bank Southwest, moving your generation in the right direction. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Deaf Smith County Hospital District helps our community senior citizens get the most out of life. Our Medicare Wellness Center provides free annual wellness visits for Medicare enrollees. Our team works with you to get up to date on screenings, immunizations, and other preventative care. Together, we review your medical history, assess your risk factors for illness, and discuss ways to reduce risks and promote health. With an annual Medicare wellness visit, you get a personalized prevention plan focused on your good health. Visit dschd.org or call 806-364-7512.
Needing extra income? Looking for a full-time job with advancement opportunities? McDonald's in Hereford is hiring full-time and part-time people who are energetic and customer-focused. At McDonald's, you will be able to work flexible hours, whether it's 3 hours or 8 hours per day. Benefits include a free meal when you're working and a 30% discount when you're off-duty. Earn a vacation benefit and $10 an hour and above with experience. To apply, just text TX162 to 38000.
First Financial Bank knows how important a person's vehicle can be.
My SUV is perfect for taking clients to properties and me to the golf course.
My pickup hauls work supplies all week and the family on weekends.
My hybrid helps the environment and my fuel bill.
If you're ready for a new vehicle, talk to First Financial. We offer loans at competitive rates with fast local approval. My 4x4 works hard, but plays even harder. First Financial Bank. You first. Member FDIC.
All right, the Lady Bulldogs have just been introduced, and now the Whitefaces up next.
And now,
as
let's meet your Lady Whitefaces.
Lady Whitefaces include Kendall Blair, Samantha Grajeda, Cambry Smith, Sahiri Sanchez, Azalea Alanis, Arissa Alanis, Aubrey Devon, Autumn Wilburn, Mitzel Rodriguez, Lindsay Carbajal, London Baker, and Aubriana Salinas Sturgeon. Coach Taylor, Coach Kelly, and Coach McKelvey, the coaches for the Lady Whitefaces. And the Whitefaces all have been introduced, and we're ready to play some basketball here on KPAN, AM and FM, Hereford, Texas. Tonight is the coaches against cancer, and money's raised for that, Coach.
Our student council will... they're selling T-shirts tonight, and they will again next Friday night to raise some money. They'll pass around a bucket at both the boys and the girls' halftimes today and next week as well. And Lucy Caballero is the person that we are they're raising money for. And so she's been a librarian and a science teacher over at Hereford Junior High and HPA for many years, and she's just a she is a mainstay with us and going through some tough old times. So hopefully we can get some money raised for the efforts that she's making as far as treatment.
She is a really, really sweet lady. You're exactly right. So if you're out here tonight or coming out here tonight, that's where the monies are going, and we would appreciate your helping out, however you could do that. Here we go, Aubrey. Back.
Hereford ISD. We are committed to children and dedicated to excellence. Hereford ISD encompasses over 900 square miles. We educate approximately 4,000 students each year and employ approximately 650 employees. Hereford ISD buses over.
There's 7:41 left in the first quarter. The Whitefaces with the basketball. Yeah. Lindsay Carvajal at the line. Free.
Hereford ISD. We are committed to children and dedicated to excellence. Hereford ISD encompasses over 900 square miles. We educate approximately 4,000 students each year and employ approximately 650 employees. Hereford ISD buses over 700 students to and from school each day. We provide 14 bus routes and drive over 1,100 miles per day. We choose to make a difference in the lives of all of our children. Go Herd!
Out to Azalea. She drives inside, outside.
Hit it.
3-point shot up short. But then throws it in the backcourt, and Borger comes up with the ball. Borger threw it back in the backcourt, Whiteface ball. Borger stole it on the Hereford side and then passed back into the backcourt. And so the Whitefaces get the turnover. 1-0 Hereford, 6:34 left in the quarter, inbounds to Azalea. Azalea on the right side of Devon, back out to Azalea. Back to Devon as they stay way out. Oh, Devon, long three. It is nothing but net. 4-0. She was a good 6-8 feet outside the 3-point. And wow, big league shot, Aubrey Devon. And it's a 4-2 ball game. Devon, another three. Nope, doesn't take it this time. Azalea takes the three. It's good, and it's 7-2 Hereford. So back-to-back threes by the Whitefaces, first by Devon, then by Azalea, and it's 7-2. 5:48 in the first quarter, Whitefaces on top. Borger with the ball. We're having trouble with the signal. I apologize. Borger inside to Northcutt. She shoots. Ball is blocked. It's out of bounds off of Borger's ball. Good job, Autumn, on the inside. Northcutt on the outside, top of the circle pass. Let's get it back to Briscoe on the left side. She shoots a long three. It's nowhere near the mark, and it's Whiteface. Oh, really? Well, I'm not sure. I guess we did, or they wouldn't have said that. 7-2, still Borger's ball.
They wouldn't still have the ball.
No. They pass it in the corner, baseline, back to the top of the circle. Around the right side now, Briscoe with the ball. Briscoe throws it inside. Low post, back outside for a three. It's up, it's no good. Rebound, Whitefaces, Lindsay Carvajal. Lindsay to Kendall, back the other direction we go. Cross midcourt now, Zaya right side to Devon. She's got another long three. She is no good, but rebound to Lindsay. Inside, Lindsay's fouled. And the foul's on Borger's Loftus. And it's two shots for Lindsay. Wow. I wasn't quite sure she was shooting, but I guess she was. 7-2 for one out of two. No.
The world sure is a different place than it was back in 1937 when Deaf Smith Electric Cooperative began. For 85 years, our commitment to our members to provide affordable, reliable electricity has been unwavering. When your lights go out, so do we, and that's something that won't ever change. Deaf Smith Electric Cooperative, your Touchstone Energy Co-op.
All right, back at Whiteface Gym, 9-2 Hereford on top. Bucket, that last bucket by Autumn Wilburn. We've had a couple of threes, one by Devin, one by Azalea. And the Whitefaces playing pretty good basketball right now. Borger walks it up the floor. It's Horst with the ball across midcourt. Lindsay has her. She gets a little bit of a pick but loses the ball, gets it back. Back out to Northcutt. Northcutt inside, down low. Back to the outside. They shoot the three. It is up, no good. Rebound off to Borger. Back it goes to Briscoe. Briscoe goes down the lane, puts it off the glass. It's no good. Rebound, no good, but a foul on the Whitefaces. Loftus got the rebound inside. The foul was on the Whitefaces. Aubrey Devin, her first, the team's first. And the 4:22 left first quarter. Borger inbounds it. Hereford knocks it back out of bounds. Loftus down on the low post. She and Briscoe are the two shooters inside to Loftus. Ooh. Wow, Loftus got away with one there. The foul is on Aubrey, but Loftus, I thought, jumped back into Autumn. Here is Grajeda going to check in after the first of two free throws by Loftus. 9-2 Hereford, 4:20 left, first quarter of play. Up it goes, and in it goes, 9-3. Sam comes in. And Lindsay comes out. So the Whitefaces have a couple of seniors out there at the moment, two juniors and a freshman. Two seniors are Aubrey and Autumn. 9-3 now, second chance for Loftus here. 4:20 left first quarter. Whitefaces by six. Up it goes, in it goes. Nice touch by Loftus. She comes out of the ball game now. She's replaced by Lumpkin. Whitefaces by five. Full court pressure, it looks like, for the Bulldogs. Inbounds, Hereford handles the press quite easily. Blair comes into the forecourt, passes off on the right side now to Samantha. Down on the baseline it goes, back to Blair. Blair inside to Autumn. Autumn back to Blair. Nice little give and go and up and in. Blair with the bucket. Assist to Autumn Wilburn, 11-4 Hereford. Inside 4 minutes to play, first quarter. Borger on the right side, stops the dribble, passes back out front now over to Pettit. Pettit gets it inside. They go down the lane. Ball taken away by Devin. Devin just ripped it away from Lumpkin. Hereford gets it back. Almost always a jump ball, but not tonight. 3:35 left first quarter. But pass inside, knocked out by Borger. Still be Borger's ball. Zay tried to go pretty deep with it that time, and maybe a little too deep. But we maintain possession. Autumn comes out, and Rodriguez comes in. 3:33 left in the quarter. Hereford up 11-7. Inbounding the ball, Azalea brings it in to Grajeda. Top of the circle now. Back to Azalea. She works to her left, goes to the baseline, can't shoot. Back outside, open for a three, but Blair takes it in. A great pass by Blair. Draws the foul. Mitzel couldn't get the bucket to go, but a nice assist there at pretty close range, too.
Yep. good start offensively for the Lady Whitefaces this first quarter.
Yep. We've had first free throws no good. We have not been great at the free throw line, Coach, all year long. We're 2 out of 5, I think, here tonight, something like that, first quarter. Second free throw is up. She missed them both. And the rebound, though, comes to Blair. The ball's loose and picked off by Borger. Back the other way come the Bulldogs. Fernandez into the forecourt. Fernandez gives it off to Castaneda. On the outside, pass almost lost, but they get it back inside now, down low, off the board. No good. Rebound Borger. Bulldogs will go again now as they get a second chance, trying to work the ball down on the low post. Down the lane we go, but Whiteface's good defense. Borger travels. Borger gets it back. That time Fernandez shuffled the feet before she put it on the floor. 2:48 left in the quarter. We lead by 7. Inbounds now. The Whitefaces again handle the press easily. They bring it in the forecourt. Isaiah's got it on the left side. Top of the circle pass goes to Grajeda. Samantha goes to her left. Tries to get in there. Has the ball taken away. Borger back the other direction. Bulldogs lose the handle. It's out of bounds off of Hereford. 2:29 left in the quarter. Borger subbing back now. They bring Garcia into the ball game. Whitefaces are doing a good job defensively early on here. Sanchez comes in for Blair. 2:29 left in the quarter. 11-4 Hereford. Inside now. Whitefaces collapse. Back outside. Borger can't shoot. Great defense again by Hereford. Borger bounces it to the low post. She goes up with it, misses the shot. Rebound Hereford. I think we've got a foul on Borger. Yep. Borger's bridges with the foul. Hereford's ball. 11-4 lead with 2:15 left in the quarter. Samantha comes up near midcourt now, and the freshman crosses the midcourt line, works to her left. Goes down the lane, passes off in the corner. We're open for a three. It's no good. Rebound off to Hereford. Ball went out of bounds off Borger, so it's Hereford's ball. Well, we've had a couple of good looks on the threes, but the last two times, we missed both of them. But we still have the ball here. Inbounds pass.
Oh, gosh.
Mitzel, the pass got banged around, and she had to reach down for it. She apparently stepped on the line or something of that sort happened. Arisa in, Azalea out. Inside, just inside, 2 minutes to play first quarter. The Whitefaces leading 11-4. Borger up the court. Garcia on the right side with a pass to Castaneda down on the baseline. In the lane, little jumper, no good. Rebound, Devin. Devin to Arisa. Arisa, another of the freshmen, all the way down the floor with a left-handed dribble off on the baseline. Grajeda goes down the baseline, draws the foul. That'll be 5 against Borger. 1:37 left in the quarter. The foul is on Fernandez. Still be Hereford's ball, leading by 7 with 1:37 left in the quarter. Arisa ready to put it in play. She does to Devin. Around the horn they work it. Sanchez, Grajeda. Samantha out on the point. Right side pass now. Goes to Arisa. Arisa works to her left. Outside Devin for 3. It's no good. Rebound off to Borger and a foul on the Whitefaces. Blair going to come back in with 1:19 left in the quarter. Hereford leading 11-4. 3 fouls against Hereford. We've gone a little cool here in the late going of the quarter. It's 3 threes in a row that we've missed. Here comes Borger up the floor, across midcourt. They've had Briscoe on the sideline for much of this quarter.
I know, it surprised me.
On the outside now, Borger at the top of the circle. That's Fernandez. Around the perimeter she goes. Gives it off, but again, good defense by the Whitefaces. They throw it down low this time. Hit the shot, draw the foul. That's Lumpkin. Lobbed it over us. And the Whitefaces, Samantha Grajeda, trying to block the shot. Did not.
Lumpkin and made it anyway.
She did.
Went up strong.
11-6, Lumpkin can make it a 4-point game now with 59 seconds left in the quarter. She shoots the free throw. Crowd growing here at the Whiteface Gym. She makes the free throw. 11-7, here we go quickly now. Arisa down the floor, throws it inside to Grajeda. We've got a whistle, another foul, I think, on Borger. 54 seconds. We almost got the Nice break make bucket, but the foul was on Borger's Cali Garcia. Hereford will inbound it now with 54 seconds left in the quarter. Got to hurry. Get it in to Blair down low. Blair back out to Arissa. Little jumper. No good. Rebound off to Borger. Bulldogs have a chance to whittle in the four-point lead all the way down. Nice pass. Shot no good, but a foul on the Whitefaces. That's two on Samantha. And so Lindsay comes back in, or will after the first free throw. 41 seconds left in the quarter. We're up by four, but the Bulldogs creeping back here after trailing by seven. First free throw goes up. It's good.
They haven't missed a one so far.
Nope. They haven't, and we have. 11-8. Gracie Ortega's the shooter. The Whitefaces bring Azalea back in along with Lindsay, Mitzel, Kendall, and Arissa. 11-8. Now she can make it a two-point game, and she does not. But the rebound, now finally Hereford gets the rebound. Almost got an offensive board there. Azalea up the floor now. Borger all over her. Ball's out of bounds off Borger. Five fouls against the Whitefaces, six against Borger here in this first quarter. 31 seconds left in the period. Hereford inbounds it two. Oh, no one. Not a good pass at all. Borger now throws it away, going the other way. 25 seconds left in the quarter. Hereford gets it back. We sometimes try to make passes that just simply aren't there.
Yeah.
Here we go. Kendall now up the floor against the full court pressure. Gets to midcourt. Oh, ball stolen by Borger. There's a foul on Kendall. And they'll shoot two more. Three-point Hereford lead. Borger scored the last 4 points and got a chance to make this spurt a little bit longer. 12.85 seconds left in the first quarter. And the Whiteface is... three-point lead in jeopardy here as the first free throw goes up. It's good, 11-9. Bulldogs back within two. We're shooting your free throws. Very, very important if you can do that. Second chance here for the Bulldogs. Up it goes. They miss it.
Gosh.
Ooh, rebound. Wow. Borger. Wow. Jump ball. I thought we had some pretty serious contact. Yep, on the... rebound, but no call. So Borger still has the ball as the jump ball gives it back to the Bulldogs. 10 seconds left. A chance to tie or take the lead here in this first quarter. Bulldogs inbound at two. The baseline and up and good by Lumpkin. We're tied at 11. 5 seconds left. I'm not sure Azalea knows there's 3 seconds left in the quarter. She shoots. It's no good at the buzzer. We're tied at 11 after one quarter. Back in 1 minute.
Whatever your type of home, experience a new level of home comfort with the new Bryant Evolution system. When installed with the Evolution Connects control, this advanced system can communicate with both your indoor and outdoor units for increased comfort and efficiency. Ask your Bryant dealer about an Evolution heating and cooling system today.
Call Bob's Heating and Air at 364-1195, your local factory-authorized Bryant dealer.
As the new year unfolds, new projects are born. If you are interested or have any questions regarding a consumer or commercial loan, First National Bank of Hereford can assist you. You will be working with Hereford's only locally owned bank. Applying is easy with our online consumer application, or visit any of our locations to apply for your personal or business needs. First National Bank of Hereford and Friona Banking Center. We have roots where others have branches. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
All right, back here at Whiteface Gym. I think the Whiteface cheerleaders are being asked to kind of spread out so they're not too deep in any places, because it is very shallow at the ends of the court. Hereford's ball to begin the second quarter. Borger scored the last 7 points of the quarter, and oh my goodness, there's a foul finally called on Lumpkin. Thought she was going to get away with another one. That's the seventh against Borger, or the sixth?
One.
Seventh, it is. Kendall goes to the line. We've got six, they've got seven. Borger has been much better at the free throw line thus far than we have. First shooter will the shooter will be Kendall Blair, again the junior. 11-11, just underway in the second quarter. No good. Tipped away, picked up by the Whitefaces, then lost, and Borger winds up with the ball. Back the other way, quickly come the Bulldogs now across midcourt. Right side pass. Outside the three-point line, Northup down the left corner. Whiteface is in good stead there. Borger way back out to the right side. Down the baseline, little give and go. Ball taken away. Nice play by Lindsay. Autumn wound up with the ball. Now up the floor, now the Whitefaces start. 11-11 game now. Kendall Blair in the forecourt. Free throws, and here's a whistle and a foul on the Whitefaces. Aubrey Devon for a moving screen. Wow. All right, seven fouls aside, 7:21 left. Well, that time she thought, and I did too, I thought she had the screen set pretty well. The official said she moved, so Borger's got a chance to take the lead for the first time tonight. In the forecourt, the Bulldogs at the top of the circle with a basketball. It's Northcutt. Pass it back. Shoot a long, long, long three that's nowhere near the mark. Lindsay has the rebound. And Carvajal up the floor. Throws it ahead now to Azalea. We've got a long time without scoring here. The Whitefaces need a bucket. Azalea almost threw it away, but saved by Autumn. No shot for Aubrey. She needs some help. Nice little pass inside. Shot up and no good. Rebound. Blair up. No good. Rebound Borger. Borger quickly now up the court. He's still 11-11. 6:36 left in the half. Borger in the forecourt with the ball. Garcia passes back outside. Now Northcutt's got it. She drives down the baseline, puts it off the glass. It's 13-11. And Borger has now scored nine in a row. 6:19 left in the half. Kendall across midcourt. Goes down the baseline. Passes off to Autumn. Off the glass, we're tied at 13. Whitefaces break a long drought. 6:08 left in the half. Borger back the other way. On the outside, it is Garcia. Dribbles around the right side, throws it down low, gets it to Northcutt. We foul again. Eighth foul against the Whitefaces.
Oh, my goodness.
Borger's getting it in low. Fouls on Kendall that time. Two free throws for Borger now. Eighth foul against the Whitefaces. Seven against Borger. 5:58 left in the half, tied at 13. Here's Northcutt trying to give Borger the lead, and she does. 14-13 Borger. Hereford with three subs in. Blair comes out. Devin comes out, and Wilburn comes out. We've got Rodriguez and Grajeda, along with Sturgeon. Azalea and Lindsay. Misses the second free throw. The rebound is loose, and again, Carvajal, she does a lot for us, getting loose balls and what have you. Hereford quickly down the floor on the baseline. Shot no good by the Whitefaces, but the rebound again to Carvajal. Back inside, Grajeda down low, throws it away. Finally saved by Rodriguez. Azalea shoots a three, it's good.
Oh, good.
16-14. After all that, we get a three-point bucket to reclaim the lead. 5:30 till the half. Borger inside, baseline, or left corner, three-point shot goes in. Horst with the three, it's 17-16 Borger. Azalea back the other direction. 5:18 left in the half. The junior passes to Carvajal. Carvajal looking inside. Back to the top of the circle. Rodriguez. Rodriguez left side pass to Azalea. We've got a whistle and a foul. No, a three-second call. Oh, that's two of those this year already.
There's a rash. Of
wow. 17-16 Borger. 5:05 left in the half. Borger across midcourt. Garcia with the ball. Inside now to Loftus. Loftus dribbles through the lane, passes back outside. Back into Loftus, down low. She misses the shot. Azalea with a rebound. Azalea lead pass now to Lindsay. Back to Azalea. She drives in the lane, can't shoot. Now takes a little step and does shoot, and it's called for a travel. 4:39 till the half. We trail 17-16. Borger has the ball. And we can't find any rhythm, folks.
No, I'm telling you, we started out hotter than a pistol, and we have gone about that cold.
Just can't find any kind of rhythm. Borger's doing a good job. moving the ball, getting the ball in the paint, getting it down low. We've committed eight fouls. Borger's got it inside again. Baseline now for North. It's no good, but the rebound belongs to Borger. Back outside, they'll go again. Garcia, they work it quickly inside to Loftus. Back out, shoot a three from the right side. It's no good. Whiteface basketball, 17-16 Borger, 4:09 till the intermission. Whiteface is inbounded now to Azalea. Arissa's going to come back in on the next whistle. Azalea across midcourt. Left corner pass goes to Rodriguez. Rodriguez back to the top of the circle to Lindsay. Back it goes to Samantha. She starts inside on the baseline, steps back, shoots. It is no good. Rebound Borger. Loftus has it. Outlet pass comes now to Briscoe. Briscoe down the floor. A little left-handed layup. No good. Rebound off to no one yet. Borger still on the floor and a whistle going to be, oh, come on. Going to call Rodriguez with a foul. 3:37 left in the half. 17-16 Borger. That's a one-and-one shot. Next one will be a two-shot for Borger. Nine fouls against the Whitefaces. Lindsay out. The shooter is Michaela Horst. 3:37 till intermission. Horst, free throw is up. It's good. 18-16. How many free throws for Borger, Coach?
Borger made 5 out of 7 in the first, and they've got 2 out of 3 so far in this second quarter.
They've got 7 of 10 at the free throw line. They lead by 2, and they still lead by 2. Rebound off to Arissa, and she's fouled by Horst. We'll go at the other end and shoot 1 and 1. That's the 8th foul against Borger. 9 against the Whitefaces. 18-16 Borger. What are we at the line, Coach?
We, in the first, were 1 out of 6, and we missed 1, so we are 1 out of 7
wow.
So far.
Wow.
You got it, Arissa, right over the front.
All right, here we go. Arissa, 1 and 1. See what the freshman can do here. Now the Whiteface is really struggling offensively. She makes it 18-17. Second chance now as her fellow freshman. Grajeda comes in to say something to Arissa, and she misses. Nope, makes them both, 18-all. Good job, Arissa, 18-all, 3:34 left first half. Here comes Horst and Borger back the other way. Horst across the midcourt line, inside now to Loftus. Ball is lost, the Whitefaces come up with it. Chance to reclaim the lead now as Grajeda comes up the floor. We're playing 4-on-5 here as the Whitefaces are without the big post, and we missed the shot and the rebound. Borger is fouled. It is Rodriguez with the foul, and we'll go at the other end, and Borger will shoot 2. Wow. Sanchez will come back in. That time, Autumn lost a shoe. She was in the backcourt, and we just went ahead and continued on, played 4 against 5 while she was getting her shoe back on. Missed the shot and then committed the foul trying to get the rebound. So Borger can reclaim the lead. Loftus, who is a good free throw shooter, is at the line. 3:08 left in the half. Puts it up. It's no good. It's 2 free throws, 2. I'm sorry, that was our 10th. So she gets a second chance here, but the score stays tied at 18. Sanchez in, Rodriguez out. Got Azalea and Autumn. Grajeda, Sanchez, and Arissa. 18-all, Loftus shoots again, and she missed them both. Rebound, though, comes to Borger. They'll get another chance. Outside now, down the lane, Briscoe off the glass, no good. Rebound to the Whitefaces. Back the other way we go. Azalea across midcourt. Passes down the left corner. We're open for a three. It's no good. Ball out of bounds off Borger, though. We're still tied at 18. 2:51, I'm telling you, we can't even draw iron now. We are really struggling. Inbounds, it comes now to Arissa. Outside to Sanchez. Back to Arissa in the corner. She doesn't take the three. Back inside, throws it away. Here's Briscoe down the floor all the way. Briscoe off the glass and in. 20-18, Borger by 2. Azalea now off to Grajeda. Ahead to Arissa. Arissa on the baseline left side. Passes into Autumn. Ball is taken away by Briscoe. 2:22. Briscoe all the way again. Forces the shot. And a foul on Grajeda. Briscoe knocks her to the floor, but the foul is on Samantha. Briscoe made the bucket. It's 22-18. 2:18 left in the half. That is three fouls on Samantha. She'll come out. Lindsay will come back in. I think, has Lindsay gotten, what's her foul situation?
Any? Lindsay does not have a foul
okay.
yet.
Okay. 2:18 left in the half. Briscoe can make it a three-point play here. And they kept her on the bench, but, man, when she's out there, especially on the breakaway, she is hard to handle. Puts it up, and it is in. 25-18, Borger by five. Full court pressure, inbounds now the Bulldogs. Briscoe on Sanchez. Ahead now to Azalea. Azalea across midcourt. Azalea goes inside in the corner. Arissa back down low to Autumn. Autumn shot blocked. Rebound Borger. 2 minutes left in the half. Briscoe with the ball. Her team with a five-point lead. Briscoe throws it away. Whitefaces get it. Pass it ahead to Lindsay. Lindsay, oh my, we had an advantage there and didn't take it. Back off now down the lane. Give it to Autumn. Off the glass, it won't go. Rebound Borger. 1:43 left in the half. Foul. No, a jump ball. Good job by Arissa to tie it up, but it is Borger's ball. 5-point lead for the Lady Bulldogs. 1:41 left first half. 23-18. Horst up the floor for Borger. We scored 11 quick points in this game, and then it has been a struggle since. Borger for three. It's nowhere near the mark. Rebound off to Sanchez. Ball knocked out of bounds by Borger. 10 fouls against Hereford. 8 fouls against Borger. 1:29 left first half.
Pressure
full
by Borger.
Full court pressure. Goodness. Inbounds to Lindsay. Lindsay starts up the floor. Stops her dribble. Needs some help. Gets it to Azalea. Azalea out near midcourt now. Gets a little bit of a screen. Dumps it back to Autumn. Autumn off the glass. 23-20. Great give and go there. And the Whitefaces back within three. Minute 10 left in the half. Horst throws it ahead for Borger. Down the left baseline. Shot. No good. Rebound. Loftus, no good. Rebound up and in. Third time's a charm for Bridges. Borger leads 25-20. Whiteface is really getting hurt on the boards. Azalea with 50 seconds left in the first half. Passes in the corner. Sanchez misses. Rebound, Sanchez misses. Rebound, Hereford still, and taken away by Borger. With 37 seconds left. Ball loose. Great hustle by the Whitefaces, but Borger still winds up with the ball. All the way down the floor, shot, no good. We've got a charge against Borger. This one on Bridges. Well,
her third.
Good job. Her third for Bridges. Comes with 28 seconds left in the first half, and Hereford trailing 25-20. Hereford will inbound the ball. Devin will come back in. Well, if we can hit a three, get a bucket here before halftime. 25-20 Borger. Sanchez out now. Inbounds to Arissa, back to Azalea, and here come the Whitefaces. 25 seconds left in the half, plenty of time. Left side, Devin. Devin around the perimeter, now to the top of the circle. Passes back to Arissa. Arissa on the left side, goes again to the top of the circle. Backdoor pass, down the baseline. Get it inside to Lindsay, off the glass, it won't go. Rebound Borger, got a great shot. Lindsay takes it back away. Borger and Lindsay call for a travel with 3 seconds left in the first half.
I thought
wow.
Loftus could get called for
too.
A foul there. Elbows flying.
3 seconds left in the half. Hereford down by five. Borger inbounds it. That's going to do it for the first half as the Whitefaces leaders early on trail by five as they head to the locker room here at the half, and just got to hope that that first half was our bad half here tonight, Coach.
Yeah, no kidding. We, let's see, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in this.
Fine.
In this third, excuse me, in this second quarter. But, boy, that ain't near enough for the Lady Whitefaces.
All right, 25-20 Borger. We'll take a 2-minute timeout and be back at Whiteface Gym.
We just trying to catch a good time, even if it takes all night. Pass that bottle around the campfire, sipping apple pie moonshine. Yeah, we picking on them guitars just right. Everybody singing Dixieland delight, like a barber on a wet line. We just trying to catch a good time. 80 degrees and the sun ain't even out. We got a spot a couple miles out of town. And when that moon comes up, you know it's going down. We got them folding chairs leaning way back. No other plans other than to relax. We ain't worried about tomorrow from where we at. We just trying to catch a good time, takes all night. Pass that bottle around the campfire, sipping apple pie moonshine. Yeah, we picking on them guitars just right. Everybody singing Dixieland delight, like a barber on a wet line. We just
halftime of the ladies game, 25-20. The lead belongs to Borger. Whiteface boys and the Borger boys out loosening up right now as they'll meet, obviously, in the second half of doubleheader here in just a little bit. What do you got for us numbers-wise first half, Coach?
Looking here, free throw. I mean, it could have been a whole lot worse free throw-wise, yeah, because of so many fouls. 8 of 14. They cooled off. Borger cooled off, yeah, just a little bit from the free throw line in the second quarter. Had a great, yeah, first quarter. Well, Lady Whiteface is led tonight so far by Autumn Wilburn. She's got 6. And Azalea Alanise has got 2 threes, a 3 in each quarter for 6 points as well. So Lady Whiteface is 3 of 9, just 3 of 9 from the free throw line. And, Lordy, if we're going to have those kinds of fouls, we need to we've got to make free throws, man.
Yeah, the fouls were relatively frequent there in the first half, and some went uncalled even in the first half, I thought. But
it was some got called that you thought, oh, that's a what? And then others just, I mean, somebody's elbow in your chops and it wasn't called.
Two areas where we struggle and have for much of the year, honestly, is offensive boards. We give up too many offensive boards. And then at the free throw line, like we talked about. And then tonight, I mean, this has kind of been our modus operandi, too. We go through real, real long cold spells.
Yeah.
And we had one of those here tonight.
Because we opened up great.
Yeah.
I mean, it had all the makings of, my gosh, it's going to be a great night. And then it's just been flat ever since.
It has. 11-7 we led. And then it was 11-all by the end of the quarter. Well, we led 11-4, 11-all by the end of the quarter, and now here the second quarter we were outscored by 5, and Borger has that 25-20 lead. So the Bulldogs, it's a big game for both teams. Borger, you know, it's probably a must-win for us too in many ways, but certainly it is for Borger with a record of 3-5. We are 5-3 in the district, and man, if we could figure out some way to win this thing in the second half, it would be most helpful.
Well, Borger, I think Borger is playing pretty solid on both ends of the floor. And Lady Whitefaces, man, we can't buy a bucket. And then when something good does happen, it doesn't spark us on. It doesn't change anything.
Well, Briscoe, I don't know what the limited playing time amounted to, but you know when she's out there, man, she's so quick and on anything. Fast break-wise, I mean, she can get you in trouble in a hurry. And she did a couple of times. I don't know what. She went up at 7 points.
Yep.
So we've got to figure all this out and got to find a way to get hot. We need somebody. We hit a couple of threes, and then we kind of went cold in that category too. And it would be good if Aubrey could find a range here tonight in this second half. So it's 25-20, Borger on top. Whiteface boys will come up after this one concludes here tonight. Good crowd at Whiteface Gym. We just visited with our old buddy Chad Clements a moment ago. Cade is one of the varsity basketball players for the Borger Bulldogs. Cade Clements is. He's a senior, and his dad's here to Rudy Moan tonight against the Whiteface. Borger's got a couple of big guys. I don't know what their lineup looks like, but this will be our first time to meet them in district play this year. We'll, you know, the girls, let's see, is that right? Did I tell that? Yeah, that's right. The girls, this is the boys' seventh district game. And so we'll end the season at Borger, and that could be a huge game for both these two teams here too. So.
Oh, and I remember what it was like at Borger with our boys last year. And
wasn't good, was it?
No, it was not good.
All right, Whitefaces trail 25-20 in the ladies' game. We'll take a 60-second break and be back at Whiteface Gym.
Did you know that every internet-connected device poses a risk to your home network? Protect IQ from WTRT and WT Services provides an extra layer of protection by blocking viruses, malware, and malicious attacks. It even works on devices such as smart thermostats and video doorbells. Protect your home today by adding Protect IQ to your internet service plan. Don't have the WT Smart Home app? Download it in app stores today.
Happy State Bank is more than just a financial institution. We're a mainstay in the lives of the customers we serve and the communities we live in. We put our customers first, making sure each experience at Happy is a great one, while taking care of all their banking needs. We pride ourselves on giving back to our local community. We partner with organizations that do the same. Happy State Bank, we're always banking with you in mind. Find out more about joining us at happybank.com. Happy State Bank, a division of Centennial Bank, member FDIC.
When life's unexpected moments happen, you can rest easy knowing Prairie Insurance is on your side. Prairie Insurance will listen to you and help tailor a policy to meet your needs. They offer multiple insurance products, including home, auto, business, and farm insurance, with the knowledge to make sure you're covered. Give them a call at 363-6489 or stop by their office at 213 West Park Avenue. When you're ready to have peace of mind regarding the things that matter most, call Prairie Insurance at 363-6489 or stop by 213 West Park Avenue and they'll make sure you're covered.
One of the most difficult things we experience in life is losing a loved one. So when that time comes, please make sure you place your loved one in the hands of people that truly care about your family and the service that your family deserves when experiencing loss. There is nothing more important at that time, so allow Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home to take care of those needs with the utmost respect for you and your family. Hereford's only family-owned and operated funeral home. Our family, serving your family.
All right, Tom and Brenda back courtside here at the Whiteface Gym. 25-20, the Lady Bulldogs lead the Lady Whitefaces here at the intermission. And the Whitefaces again needing a win here tonight. Postseason possibility. It was 5-3, and here's what we've got left. Here tonight at Borger, on the road Tuesday night at Pampa, back here next Friday night against Dumas. Then we go to West Plains. We come back here and play Randall, and then we go to Canyon. And that will conclude the regular season. So, you know, I feel like if you're 7-7, you're going to probably be in some kind of a situation where you're in a playoff, but that's not any assurance. I mean, 8-6 would probably, I would say, would guarantee you some kind of a third or fourth place finish or a chance to get in third or fourth. 7-7, so we're at 5 wins right now. That means we're 2 wins away, if you will, from what would be a situation where we'd have a chance to be in the playoffs, and we're probably 3 wins away from where we'd be guaranteed a place in the playoffs. But first things first, and the first thing here tonight is for the Whitefaces to try to figure out a way to get this win in a game in which we trail 25-20. It'll be Hereford's ball to start the second half. We've got Lindsay and Devin and Autumn and Kendall and Azalea. Here we go. Azalea with the ball out at midcourt. Passes on the right side. Oh, there's Briscoe with a quick foul. She nearly took Kendall's head off trying to make a steal. It would have been a great steal had she made it, but it was not very close to a steal. It was much more close to an assault.
Well, we've got to meet our passes,
we do.
Too. We were just waiting on the basketball to get to us, and Briscoe will come get it.
Here's Azalea now in the forecourt. Back out front she goes to pass it to the left side back to Azalea. Now Devin at the top of the circle. Briscoe on her. Devin to the bucket. She's fouled, and she'll shoot two. So just like that, two quick fouls on Borger. The foul is on Loftus. It's her second. And the Whitefaces have two free throws here. Aubrey Devin's the shooter. 25-20 Borger leads. First one's good, 25-21. Devin can make it a three-point game here now. We're just underway in this, the third quarter, and this one won't go. And there's a foul on Autumn trying to go over Loftus. And she gets called for going over the back. So we get a foul. We don't get the free throw. We trail by four. Borger's got the ball. Well, here comes Horst up the floor. I'll tell you what, and this is us too. Well, here's Northcutt. I'll keep it here. Inside Loftus. Loftus shoots and misses. Hereford touched it last. I was going to say, you cannot carry the basketball anymore. You can just almost take it on the bottom and roll it over. Inbounds from Briscoe. The ball knocked away, and Lindsay winds up with it, and Whiteface is down by four. Now have a chance to cut into the lead. Carbajal for three. It's no good. Rebound back to Azalea. Azalea inside to Kendall off the glass and in. She's fouled, and that's three quick fouls against Borger in the first minute of the third quarter. And a chance for Kendall to make it a one-point game with a three-point play here. She hit the bucket. She's got one free throw. That was the first foul on Northcutt. Kendall shoots. It's good. 25, that ought to count too. I mean, she didn't hardly hit the bottom of the net. It was so smooth. 1 point Borger lead, 7 minutes left, third quarter. Briscoe outside, goes inside, forces and misses the shot. Rebound, Autumn. Off to Azalea, head now to Kendall. And Kendall throws it away, trying to get the fast break bucket and got in a little too big a hurry. Turnover gives it back to Borger. Borger with the ball and a 1 point lead. Here's Horst up the floor for the Lady Bulldogs. Passes right side to Briscoe. Briscoe starts inside, wheels around, throws it in the corner. Inside now to Loftus. Back outside, Briscoe shoots a three and misses, and the rebound belongs to Lindsay. Good job by Carbajal. Carbajal now to Blair. 6:21 left third period. A chance to take the lead for the Whitefaces here, trailing by one. Give it off now to, wow, Briscoe banged into Kendall again. Outside now, the Whitefaces just not moving the ball. 6:05 left, third period. Kendall goes down baseline, misses the shot, rebound, Briscoe. Briscoe.
Gosh, dang.
Foul's going to be on Kendall, I think. Wow. Briscoe throwing elbows right and throwing elbows right and left. Out comes Kendall, in comes Rodriguez. Still a 1 point lead for Borger. They've got the ball. Inside, 6 minutes to play, third period. Horst up the floor for Borger. Comes across midcourt. Lindsay picks her up. She drives in, dumps it off to Loftus. Loftus makes a great shot. The lead is three. Loftus is very strong on the inside. And she just went up in traffic. There's Hereford. The throw gets away from the Whitefaces, out of bounds, off of the Whitefaces. So Borger with good pressure. And they create the turnover. They have the three-point lead in the ball now. 5:30 left third period. Horst back the other way. Aubrey almost got the steal but didn't. Briscoe shoots a three and makes it. 30-24 now. Borger by six. Their biggest lead of the night. Whitefaces had cut it back to one. Now timeout Hereford. 5:13 left third quarter. We'll take a 30-second break. Be right back.
Did you know that all prepaid funeral plans are transferable? If you purchased a prepaid funeral plan through another funeral home, you are not in any way obligated to use that funeral home in your time of need. The Texas Department of Banking and the Texas Department of Insurance allow individuals to change funeral homes and use a funeral home of their choice. Allow Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home and our licensed funeral directors to explain the easy process of transferring your funeral plan. Hereford's only family-owned and operated funeral home. Our family serving your family.
Well, back at Whiteface Gym, we're down by six. And again, we're just out of sync, out of whack. I don't know what it is. Yeah. Borger's obviously got something to do with it.
Yeah, they do. But, I mean, it just seems like our speed, our pace is not very crisp. It seems like we're somewhat confused, don't know what we're running or aren't running any.
Inbounds now from Devin. Oops, the return pass almost threw that one away. Aubrey wasn't looking, and the return pass almost went out of bounds. She's got it on the point. Right side pass to Azalea. Azalea gets a little pick there, a little give and go inside, but Autumn can't shoot. Makes a good save to get it back outside. 4:55 left, third period. Borger's man-to-man causing problems for the Whitefaces. Devin open for three. It's no good. Rebound off to Lindsay, and Lindsay gets banged, and we've got a couple of fouls there. They're going to call the second one, I think. Fouls on Northrop, her second. Wow. That is four against Borger here in this quarter. That was a double foul there. They fouled twice before they called one. Inbounds now Isaiah to Lindsay, and she can't get it to go. Rebound off Whitefaces, and a foul. Wow, what a foul on Northrop on Azalea. Good job by the Whitefaces there to stay after it. That's three fouls on Northrop.
In just this second half.
Yep. And the last two have come within 3 seconds of one another just about. Down by six, Azalea shoots 30-24. Borger on top. Marissa going to come in on the whistle. Free throw is good. 30-25. Marissa in, and who's out? Out comes Lindsay. Borger brings Bridges back in. She's playing with three fouls. Northrop, who went out, has three fouls. 4:38 left, third quarter. Makes one of the two. 30-25. Borger leads by five. Here comes Briscoe. Briscoe in the forecourt, can't drive this time. Pulls it back out. Gives it away to Bridges. Ooh, Bridges lost it, but got it back. Borger now, and there's a foul on Rodriguez. She reached in. That is her third. That's the third against the Whitefaces here in this half. We're down by five and just reached in and got whistled there. Whitefaces. Borger now on the outside. I'm going to set it up again. In it goes. There's a travel. Whitefaces get it back. Lumpkin that time got the pass. Shuffled her feet as she went to the bucket. So Hereford's ball. Down by five. 4:08 left, third quarter. Let's go, girls. Let's get going. Azalea's got the ball. Arissa's on her right. Devin's on her left. Pass now goes to Grajeda. Sam at the top of the circle. Gives it way outside to Autumn. Autumn trying to work a little give and go there. Little backdoor pass to Aubrey. Up and in. What a shot by Aubrey. 30-27. Whitefaces down by three. 3:45 left, third period. Borger back the other way. Borger throws it inside, almost threw it away. Fortunate to get it back. Here's Horst on the outside now with Arissa on her. She forces a shot and draws the foul. She'll shoot two. I mean, Horst just threw up something that was absolutely nowhere close to going in the bucket. It was a terrible shot, but we fouled her, and she shoots two free throws. 30-27, Borger by three. 3:31 left, third quarter. Free throws up, it's good. 31-27. Whitefaces bring Sturgeon in. Autumn comes out. 3:31 left in the quarter. We're down by four. Second chance for Michaela Horst here as she puts it up, and she misses, and the rebound belongs to Borger. Down low, shot, no good. Rebound off to Grajeda. Here comes Azalea back the other way. We're down by four with 3:22 left, third period. Ahead to Sam. She brings it around the perimeter now, passes left side off to Arissa. Arissa in the corner to Grajeda. Grajeda goes in the lane, puts the shot up. It's no good. Rebound, Borger. Here comes Briscoe and Borger back the other way. Briscoe going to, oh, she double dribbles. Whitefaces get it back. Briscoe can do some great things, but she too gets a little hurried. And
yeah, gets a little bit out of control. Yep. She's coming out.
3 minutes left, 2:59 actually in the third quarter. The Whitefaces down by four with the ball. Samantha in the backcourt. Fernandez on her. Throws it long, throws it away. Tried to save in the corner, Azalea did, but bad pass by Samantha that time in the lead. Four, and we turn the ball over without getting a shot away. Wow. Borger back the other way. Castaneda. She's out on the point. She passes right side now as they've got Tolliver in there. Down low, shot up and good by Bridges. It's a six-point Borger lead. 2:35 left, third quarter. At midcourt, the pass ahead now to Samantha. On the outside, the freshman works to her right, takes it to the bucket. Shot up, no good. Rebound, Borger. 2:20. Rebound inside, Borger gets it, Lumpkin. Now the ball's loose, out of bounds, off Borger. 2 minutes, 1 second left in the period. We're down by six. We've just got to get something going here, folks. Borger again with full court pressure. Samantha up the court. Fernandez on her. Dribbles here. Gets trapped. Gets it ahead now to Azalea on the baseline. 15-footer. It's no good. Rebound Aubrey. Back up. It's no good. Rebound Borger. Back the other way come the Bulldogs. Tolliver down the floor. All the way down the floor. Taken away by Grajeda. Back the other way go the Whitefaces. Samantha. We've got a whistle and a foul, and she'll shoot two. And the foul is on Lumpkin. And I'll talk about it on our end as well. We got saved by a foul.
Yep.
We did not have a good shot there. We took it into traffic, and fortunately we got a whistle and a foul on Borger. Their sixth foul in the second half. Hereford's got four. 33-27. Two free throws for Samantha. First one's up. It's good. 33-28. Borger brings Tolliver out, and Garcia replaces her. 1:32 left, third period. Borger by five over the Lady Whitefaces. Second free throw, she made them both. 33-29, four-point lead. Borger back the other way. Garcia on the outside now. They whip it down the left corner. Back out to Garcia. Garcia over on the right side. A little give and go inside, but good defense by the Whitefaces. Borger shoots a three. It's no good. Rebound off to Grajeda. Samantha in the backcourt with Fernandez on her. Comes by her across midcourt. Fernandez pushing her all the way. Back outside now to Arissa. Minute left in the period. Arissa to the bucket. And a jump ball. It'll be Borger's ball. Well, Borger does a good job. We've just kind of gone into the lane, honestly, not very much in control more than once here tonight. Four-point lead for the Bulldogs. 52 seconds left, third period. Garcia outside. Gives it to Castaneda. Pass goes off now to Fernandez. Fernandez, they're working a little weave out here. Fernandez or Garcia with the ball. Lost, and here is Samantha down the floor to the bucket, lays it up and in. It's a two-point game. 30 seconds left, third period. The Whitefaces battle back. Borger in the forecourt now, Castaneda. Right side, Bridges shoots a long three. It's no good, and the ball is out of bounds. It'll be Hereford's ball. 18 seconds left. Well, I don't know. Glad she shot it, but that wasn't a very good shot either.
Yeah, thank you for shooting
that. 18 seconds left in the quarter now. Hereford gets it ahead to Devin. Outside now to Arissa. 12 seconds left. Three-point shot by Devin is no good. Rebound off to Borger. Borger quickly down the floor. Now they got time. Borger shoots, and a foul on the Whitefaces. The bucket is good, and it'll be a four-point lead with a one more free throw to shoot. The foul was on Larissa. On Sam, that's four on Sam, wow. Here's Sanchez in 9/10 of a second, so not a chance to get a shot off here if Borger misses or makes, for that matter. The shooter is Lumpkin, who made that free throw. We'd gotten it back within two, and now it's five. And that's where it was at the half, and that's where it'll be when we start the final quarter. Inbounds in the backcourt. There's the buzzer. We played three, 36-31. Borger leads Hereford. We're back in 1 minute.
Heard athletes work tirelessly on the fundamentals of their particular sport while learning to work in a team concept. It's not much different at Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union. Our employees have a dedication to serve our members daily with the fundamentals of good business. Being friendly and helping give you peace of mind and knowing that when you need banking assistance, you can get it from our knowledgeable staff. Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, member NCUA, working as a team since 1936 with our members. Go Heard!
When the unthinkable happens, good neighbors show up. For 100 years, State Farm has been among the first to arrive with the latest technology and tools to help you recover faster. State Farm has been there before, and they'll be there again and again. Stop by and see your local State Farm insurance agent, Matt Silva, at 801 Main Street in Hereford. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
All right, Whitefaces trail by five as we begin the final 8 minutes here at Whiteface Gym. 36-31 Borger. And the Bulldogs, or the Whitefaces, will inbound it on the far side. Arissa, Azalea, along with Devin and Sanchez, and Sturgeon for the Whitefaces. High post to Devin. She looks back door, back to Arissa. Pulls up, 12-footer, it's no good. Rebound off to Arissa. 12-footer, it's no good. Rebound off to Sanchez, it's no good. Rebound off to Borger. Wow, we had three opportunities there. Here's Briscoe now, back the other way. She's going to the bucket, I'll tell you. She shoots a bad shot. Hereford gets the rebound. Ahead to Devin now. Just underway in the fourth quarter. Hereford down by five with the ball. Devin in the corner shoots a three. It's good. 36-34. Huge bucket there by Aubrey Devin. 7:15 to play. Borger by two with the ball. Here's Garcia on the outside. Garcia to Northam. Northcutt passes to Briscoe. Briscoe in traffic in the corner. Down the baseline. Bad shot. Rebound Hereford. Devin back the other way. Chance to tie or take the lead here with 6:56 to play. Sanchez. Oh, inside throws it away. Northcutt back the other way for Borger. They've got a three-on-three. Northcutt pulls up, jumps, shoots, and scores. 38-34. Wow. Down by four again. 6:30 to play. Here's Arissa in the backcourt. Ahead now to, or that was Elzavia, ahead to Arissa in the corner. Aubrey shoots three. It is no good. Rebound right back to Sanchez. Up and in. 38-36. 6:24 to play. Borger by two. Back the other way come the Bulldogs. Garcia with the ball. Timeout Borger. 6:18 to play. They lead by two. We're back in 30 seconds.
Since 1901, the Hereford brand has been keeping readers informed and entertained with all things Hereford. A weekly historical column, detailed recaps of city and county government meetings, and photos of your favorite Herd athlete or youngster fishing in the pond. Things have changed some since the early days, like being able to get the paper sent straight to your email. But some things have stayed the same, like providing local content you need to read. The Hereford brand, back in downtown Hereford, across from the courthouse.
All right, we've got 6:18 left to play, Coach. We're down 38-36. We have managed to stay in the thing.
We
but,
have.
We're going to have a spurt here of some kind.
Yep, we are. We're going to have to hit some shots. We're going to have to play some good defense, too, man.
Yeah.
They are they've had 11, 14, and 11 points each of these three quarters.
Borger works it inside to Loftus. Back outside now. Briscoe shoots a three. It's way off.
Get out of here.
Rebound is Hereford touched the ball. Wow. Still Borger's ball. 6:07 left. Borger inbounds the ball. Briscoe in the corner to North. She goes down, still continues to dribble. Great move by her to keep it alive. Ball's out of bounds again off Hereford. 6:01 left. Fouls, six against Borger, five against the Whitefaces. 6:01 left in the night. Inbounds, it comes to the corner. Ball taken away by Arissa. 2-on-1, fast break. Off to the Whitefaces inside, and we can't make the shot. Oh, Borger's behind us now. Loftus to the bucket. Makes the layup, and it's 40-36. The Whitefaces miss. The Bulldogs make, and it's back to four. Here's Blair in the forecourt now. Kendall on the outside, directing traffic. Passes left side to Arissa. Lindsay's back in there. Arissa. Trap gets away, gives it off inside. We lose the ball and a foul on Autumn. Loftus took the ball away and then Autumn tried to get it back but couldn't. And that is number six against the Whitefaces. 5:23 to play. Aubrey back in. Sanchez out. And Rodriguez back in and Autumn out. Borger by four with the ball. Both teams will be in the 1-1 on the next foul. 5:23 to play. The free throw line might prove to be the difference here tonight. We'll see. Garcia outside. Briscoe down in the corner to Garcia, down low to Loftus. She's fouled and scored. Wow. Loftus, we just collapsed on her. She went up and scored and drew the foul. 42-36. That's very, very hurtful. Loftus can make it a 7-point game with just over five minutes to play. She dribbles it three times, puts it up and in. 43-36. Plenty of time, but we just can't find a rhythm, and I don't know when that's going to come. Here we go outside. Whitefaces get it to Arissa. Now she works right, then left in the lane. Can't shoot. Passes back to Blair, back door to Lindsay. Lindsay up, no good. Rebound off to Borger. Back the other way come the Bulldogs. 4:44 left with a 7-point lead. Here they come, throw it away.
Thank you.
The Whitefaces get it back.
We appreciate that.
Seven.
She was down.
Yep.
Loftus was down at the block, and she caught that thing. She'd had a score.
So the Whitefaces down by seven, 4:39 left. Inbounds it comes to Kendall Blair. She gives it back to Aubrey Devon. And the Whitefaces call timeout. 4:32 left, down by seven. We're back in 30 seconds.
Oh, there's nothing like the sound of a new baby calf or the smell of fresh rain on a cotton crop. My friends at Capital Farm Credit share this excitement with agricultural and livestock producers. We want to be your lending partner. Whether you require operating funds for next year's crop or need to buy hay for your cattle, we have a loan that's right for you. Let us finance your operation. CapitalFarmCredit.com.
Okay, we've got 4 minutes, 32 seconds left to play. The Whitefaces trail by seven. It's pretty dire.
It is, and I don't know, man. I mean, they are just, Borger's just out toughing us right now. They're playing tougher than we are. Man, I don't like to say that.
Loftus down low. Boy, she's so stout in there. She and Bridges both have done a good job on the low post. And the Bulldogs get on Aubrey after she gets the inbounds pass. She'll bring it out to Arissa, and we'll set up the offense now. Arissa on the point. Backdoor pass to Lindsay. Nice give inside, off the glass, bucket by Rodriguez. Nice pass there by the Whitefaces. Two passes, actually. Arissa is going to check in, or Azalea on the next whistle. 4:09 to play. Hereford down by five. Borger's Northcutt goes to the baseline. Passes back to Loftus. Loftus is fouled. She'll shoot two more. I mean, Loftus is, if she's so strong when she gets it, she's going up. And,
I mean, that's what
we're in trouble.
You know, second half, when we played up at Borger, that's, if she didn't score, she was fouled. And, yeah. I mean, that's kind of what's going on now.
She can widen the five-point lead. She's been good at the line, and she misses this one. 4:02 to play. Borger by five. Azalea in. Arissa out. Whiteface is down by five here against the Lady Bulldogs. Tuesday night, a tough road game up at Pampa. She missed them both, and the rebound comes to Rodriguez, and the Whitefaces with the ball now down by five. Need to score. Long lead pass. Almost lost it. We did lose it out of bounds. Wow. Well, the pass was too tall, honestly, for Blair, from Blair. And instead of cutting into the five-point lead, we turn it over. Back the other way comes Borger. Outside now, Briscoe's got it. She shoots a three. It's online. It is short. The rebound is up and in by Loftus. 45-38. Loftus is killing us. We've got a whistle, and Borger's got a player down, I think. Nope, it's Lindsay that's down. I'm sorry. Lindsay Carbajal in front of the Borger bench. Hereford down by seven, 3:33 left to play, and Sarah down to look after her, Coach Taylor as well. I didn't see what happened. She's right in front of the Borger bench.
I mean, how we are sitting right now, you can't even see.
No.
But Sarah and Coach.
I could see the top of her head when I looked down first, but now I'm blocked from that. But the Whiteface is trailing by seven now with 3.5 minutes. I'm telling you, this is going to, if we can't win this thing, we're now 5-4. In the district, and again, a tough road game on Tuesday night up at Pampa, then back home for Dumas, and then West Plains, and there's Lindsay's sister, Smiley, who's a nurse, has been my nurse a couple of times, down to check on her sister. She's still seated. They haven't tried to get her up yet. Sarah is attending to her as well. Up she comes, and I don't know if it's her ankle. I can't tell. She hadn't put any weight on. Looks like her left side.
Standing pretty good.
Yeah. She's trying. She's just kind of shuffling her feet, though. Now I'm a little bit more of a step, but noticeably limping with her left leg.
All that looks good.
Now walking a bit is Lindsay back to the Whiteface bench, but obviously she's not out there now. With 7 minutes left, Arissa comes back in. So we've got Arissa, Azalea, Kendall, Metzel, and Aubrey, the five out there at the moment. We're trailing by seven. There is time with 3.5 minutes left, but we've got to score nearly every possession. I almost turned it over there. Azalea outside now. In the corner to Aubrey. She launches a three. It's good. 45-41, 3:15 to play. Another big bucket by Devin. Here comes Briscoe back the other way. Briscoe pulls it out near midcourt. She loses the ball, and the Whitefaces get it. Rodriguez down the floor. Pump fake off the glass and in. 45-43. Suddenly the seven-point lead is two. 2:57 to play. What a shot by Rodriguez. Borger quickly down the floor, shoots a three. It's no good. The rebound off to the Whitefaces. Whitefaces down by two with 2:45 left. Devin ahead now, wide open. We got a three. She takes it. It's no good. Rebound Borger. Arissa took the three. Borger back the other way in the forecourt now. North cut. Ball knocked away. 2:29 left. Timeout Borger. 45-43 lead for the Bulldogs. We're back in 30 seconds.
Start here, AC. Go anywhere. Amarillo College is the place to prepare. AC.
After serving my country in the military and a bout with colon cancer, I got a new start right here at Amarillo College. Great programs, great faculty. Start here, go anywhere.
Trust your future to a college that cares.
All right, we trail by two. Whiteface is the three by Devin, and then a great bucket by Rodriguez. I'm telling you, she was contested. She kind of hesitated in the air, banked it in. And we had a chance that time, missed the three, but Borger back with the ball. Borger's been pretty reckless with the basketball, too.
Yeah, they have. So far, Lady Whitefaces in this fourth quarter has scored 12 points, and that's more than we've scored in any other quarter so far.
Eight fouls against the Whitefaces, six against Borger. Borger with the ball in the forecourt. They inbound it to Garcia. Zegia has her. Bulldogs set a screen, pass it outside. We knock it away, but Borger gets it. Northcutt in the corner. Borger shoots a three. It's no good. Rebound is saved inbounds. Nope. Taken away by the Whitefaces. Kendall, bad shot again by Borger there. Here's Azalea in the forecourt now. Let's see if the Whitefaces can tie it up. 2 minutes to play. Down by two. Azalea around the right side now. Sets up the offense. Back out front to Devin. Back to Azalea. Azalea goes in the lane. Passes off, and it's intercepted by Borger. 1:45 left. Up to Briscoe. Briscoe in the forecourt. Passes out front. Northcutt, foul by Arissa. It'll be a 1-1 for Northcutt. 1:38 left, Borger leading by two. We've had two opportunities to tie or take the lead. Once we didn't get a very good shot off, and the last time we turned it over. Huge free throws here. The last 1-1, there'll be two shot fouls for Borger from here on. Free throw is no good. Rebound off and a foul on Borger. We'll go at the other end where Kendall will shoot. The foul was on Lumpkin over the back of Kendall Blair. 1:37 left, 45-43 Borger. 1-1 free throw for the junior, Kendall Blair. Whiteface is down by seven just a minute ago. Have a chance to win this thing here down the stretch. Kendall makes it 45-44. She can tie it up right here with 1:37 to play. Kendall puts the second one up, missed it. Rebound off to Borger. Oh, Borger ahead to Loftus. Oh, my. Loftus throws it in the corner. They shoot another three and make it. Briscoe. 48-44 Borger. That, I'll tell you again, was a poor shot, but they took it. Here's Arissa for three. It's good. 48-47. Great answer by Alanise right there. Azalea with the bucket. I said Arissa, but it was Azalea. Here's Borger. Briscoe down the baseline in traffic.
That's a walk.
Oh, Briscoe walks. They don't call it. They missed the three. Devin's got it. The Whitefaces with the ball. 57 seconds left. We're down by one. Inside. Jumper. Baseline. No good. Rebound. Up. No good. Rebound off to the Whitefaces again in the corner. Rodriguez to the bucket. Loftus fouls her with 43 seconds left. Mitchell will shoot two free throws. 48-47 Borger. What a ball game here as the Whitefaces have struggled all night long, but they're battling down the stretch here. Two free throws here. 48-47 Borger. 43 seconds to play. The junior puts the first one up. It's no good. 48-47. She'll get a second chance here. If she makes it, I think we're going to take a timeout here is my guess. Mitchell trying to tie the ball game with 43 seconds left. She missed them both. Rebound off to the Whitefaces. Azalea down the baseline. Gives it inside to Mitchell. Off the glass. Hereford leads 49-48 with 32 seconds left. Timeout, Lady Whitefaces. We'll keep it here. Great pass, great bucket, great perseverance on the part of the Whitefaces.
Oh, Lordy, now Lady Whitefaces have got to play some good defense, and you can believe Borger's Borger's going to try to work it underneath. I would have to believe inside to Loftus and see if they can get up there and get her either to score or get the foul drawn or both.
Again, any foul against the Whitefaces is a two-shot foul, as we have nine fouls here in the second half. The Bulldogs trail 49-48. First time they've trailed since, I'd say, early second quarter. The Whitefaces just down by seven at 45-38. A three by Devin, a two by Rodriguez. And now the Whitefaces, another two-point shot by Rodriguez, have taken the lead, 49-48. Yeah, Briscoe or Loftus won. I mean, if Briscoe gets it, I'm not sure she's not shooting it, but they want to get it, I would think, to Loftus. One-point Hereford lead.
And Briscoe's going to want to shoot it back.
Yep. Briscoe made the last three. Again, I don't think was a very good time to take the shot, but when it went in, it was a good time. Briscoe, 32 seconds left now, 49-48. Garcia with the ball for Borger, walks it up the floor. Across midcourt, Garcia goes to her right, gives it to Briscoe. Briscoe around the perimeter. We're down to 20 seconds. Briscoe on the baseline.
Oh, she dropped that shoulder.
Oh, my goodness. Briscoe did. Whitefaces, the call goes, though, Borger's way. And it'll be two free throws now. Briscoe with 17 seconds left. No pressure with the two free throws. Minimal pressure. The foul was on Azalea, but Azalea was really in pretty good
Briscoe
position.
Briscoe just dropped her shoulder,
she did.
Man.
She did. Briscoe shoots the first of two now. Timeout, Hereford. The Whitefaces with a one-point lead, 17 seconds to play. We're back in 30 seconds.
Your business, farm and ranch, or home is unique, and success depends in part on a cost-effective and convenient supply of quality fuel. When you trust your fueling needs to Gooden Fuels, it's one less detail for you to manage. Commercial fuel in bulk in below-ground or above-ground tanks, serving the Western Panhandle with gasoline, diesel, and propane. Gooden Fuels in Hereford, 364-3366.
But the Whitefaces would have the basketball.
Man, oh man, we need to block out.
Yep. Let's see what Briscoe does here. The Whitefaces with Grajeda and Rodriguez, Blair, Devin, and Alanis on the floor. Second free throw by Briscoe now to tie it up. Up it goes. She missed them both. Rebound off to the Whitefaces. Hereford with the ball now. 14 seconds left. They foul. Borger fouls immediately on Blair. Briscoe missed both free throws.
Come on, Miss Kendall.
Now with 13 seconds left, it's a 1-1. It is the eighth foul against Borger. So 1-1, 13 seconds left in the ball game. Hereford leads 49-48. Kendall Blair is the shooter. The junior steps to the line. Crowd. It is no good. Rebound, Borger. Clock's not running. Clock running now with 13 seconds. Borger, take it away.
Push.
By Blair, and Blair is fouled. What? Oh, no, Borger called a timeout. 9.3 seconds left. Hereford had the steal, but the Bulldogs get a timeout. The Bulldog coach upset by some no-call, I suppose, but my gosh, it looked like Hereford had the steal.
Absolutely, and then it looked like Borger pushed from their backside.
Absolutely. Well, 9.3 seconds left, a 49-48 Hereford lead. The Bulldogs with the ball at midcourt. Any foul is a two-shot foul. Coach Taylor talking to the troops to our right. The Whitefaces trying to get up off the deck and just honestly steal one here on the home court. But Borger just with the ball a bucket away from taking the lead and what might be the final lead change if they do. The Whitefaces break the huddle. Gosh, the call here, or calls or lack thereof, are going to be real critical.
Yep.
Borger with the ball.
Come on, defense.
Briscoe is going to get the inbounds pass. Loftus is down on the low post. 9 seconds to play. Inbounds to Briscoe. Briscoe now, she's going to go with the bucket. Briscoe, no, passes outside to Garcia. Left side, north cut. 2 seconds. She throws it up. It's no good. The Whitefaces have won it. 49-48. The Whitefaces have won the ball game here over the Bulldogs. The Bulldogs mishandle the ball there toward the end and lose it. 49-48. We are 6-3. I wouldn't have given you a plug nickel for our chances 3 minutes ago.
Either, Mr.
But
Simons.
We win it. 49-48. What a steal by the Whitefaces here tonight as the Bulldogs now fall to 3-6. The Whitefaces at 6-3. A game I think we just had to win, quite honestly, if we were going to look at postseason play, and somehow we got her done.
Somehow we did, and I'm going to let me count up here.
Okay.
6, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18 points in quarter number four.
Wow.
And I'm telling you, that was the difference. That was absolutely the difference. Free throws are nothing to write home about, I can guarantee you that. Just 1 for 5 in that fourth quarter. So 8 out of 21 from the free throw line for the Lady Whitefaces, which is not stellar tonight. But let me see, get some totals here. 6, 8, 9. Aubrey Devon with 2 big threes in quarter number four. That was huge.
Well, it was huge. That first one, really, when we were down by 7. That three-point shot. We'll try to visit with Coach Taylor at halftime of the boys' game, but she's still a little bit shaky right now, as are we.
I am too.
49-48.
Exactly. 12 points for Aubrey Devon. 2 threes in the fourth quarter. None were bigger. And then Mitzell with a huge fourth quarter. 6 points from her.
Wow.
Just one other point in the third quarter from her on the evening. 9 points from Azalea Alanis. 6 points for Kendall. And then we had a bucket for Sarahi and two free throws for Arissa and a point for Lindsay. Autumn, let me get Autumn. Mm-hmm. Autumn had 6 points on the night as well. So, but an 18-point fourth quarter, and it's oh, gosh, it's sickening.
49-48, Lady Whitefaces win it. We'll take a break back to Daniel for a little bit. Be back with the boys game before you know it. Whiteface ladies win by 1. Back in just a few minutes.
Take it by the hand, dancing on the glass, it'll ride. you're just like one of us, to pick up the phone and call after a couple drinks and say how you've been. I've been wondering if maybe you've been thinking about me. And somewhere in the conversation, an old familiar invitation always arrives. And I may hate myself in the morning, but I'm gonna love you tonight. Everyone's known someone that they just can't help but want. Just can't make it work out well, the want to lingers on. So once again we wind up in each other's arms, pretending that it's right. And I may hate myself in the morning, but I'm gonna love you.
Alrighty, we welcome you back to Whiteface Gym. We're just a couple of minutes away from introduction of the starters and the play here against the Borger Bulldogs. The Whiteface is now 3-3 in the district. And again, obviously, they're all important, but certainly the ones at home are most important. And the Whitefaces need to get a win against the Bulldogs here tonight. Hereford warming up the bucket down to our left. And there's just no easy ones. That's all there is to it. The Whitefaces, with a win here tonight, would be obviously 4-3 in the first round of district play. And that would put us in a position where we're probably third. I don't know for sure, but I'll check it out here in just a minute. The Whitefaces are... Let me see. We are 3-3. Borger is 1-. Borger's either, I don't know if they're 2-4, 1-5. They're one or the other. Now the Whitefaces currently are in fifth place, tied with Dumas. Perryton's 3-. I'm sorry. We are 3-3. We are tied with Perryton. West Plains. Trying to remember, I don't have, this is earlier, the scores this week. Canyon won, but I've forgotten who they played, Randall. We are currently in a tie, I think, for fourth place in the district. In any event, all the games are important. And this one here tonight on the Whitefaces home court, just like the rest of them. Coach Loftus shaking hands with the officials here. Coach Gonzalez, Peyton, Coach Garza, Hunter,
and good evening,
Coach Bell,
and
Tim.
Welcome to Whiteface Gymnasium again, for the second game of our doubleheader between the Borger Bulldogs.
We don't need to know. We need to win this decisively.
It needs to be one boring game that is all Whitefaces.
Good crowd here, the Whiteface Gym.
Senior guard, Chance Wooden.
And it got pretty loud there toward the end, as you might imagine.
Senior forward, Kate Clements.
Chance Wooden, Kay Clements.
Sophomore guard, Isaiah Fernandez.
Isaiah Fernandez.
Junior guard, Caden Jennings.
Caden Jennings.
And number 12, senior forward, Trey Tolliver.
Trey Tolliver. It's the starting five for the Bulldogs here tonight. The Whiteface is about to be introduced.
That Claudia kid looks kind of like a linebacker.
That's what he was.
That's what I'm thinking.
And that's kind of what he is. He's a good guy.
His
grandparents, of course, here in Hereford happen to be none other than Don and Adele Clements. Two pretty nice folks, I'd say, wouldn't you?
Yes, sir. For sure.
Whitefaces Hayden and Zevon Gonzalez, along with Ty. Then Diego and Jaden Fletcher. That's the five for Coach Loftus. Ball's thrown up. Well, Dayton did a great job. He got it all the way to Don. It appeared to me that Don mishandled it. It wound up down below in the hands of some young man.
I think he thought Dayton was going to get that. And
yeah.
Whole thing maybe, got messed up.
Yep.
Dodge.
Dayton threw it. It was really a good throw. He threw from this side of the court, too. But, you know, neither Don nor Dodge could handle the throw. Cade Clements out smoozing with the official. That's kind of his. He's a piece of work. He is. Here we go. Jaden jumping against Tolliver. And this basketball game getting going right here at Whiteface Gym. The end of round one for the Whitefaces and for Borger. Ty's got it, and he fires it ahead to Diego. Down low now on the baseline. Hayden's got it. Back out front to Zevon. Left side to Ty. Ty looking inside. Borger. Diego back outside in the corner. Zevon doesn't take the three. Goes down the baseline instead. And lays it up and in. Nice move, Zevon Gonzalez. Full court pressure for the Whitefaces now. In the backcourt. Borger with the ball. Up the floor they come. Ball's knocked away by Diego, but Borger gets it back. Great play by Diego and Ty. Hernandez now with the ball for the Bulldogs. 2-0 Hereford, just underway here at Whiteface Gym. Hernandez down on the baseline, can't shoot. Backdoor pass to Clements. Clements shoots off the glass and in, tied at 2. 7:04 left first quarter, 2-2 ball game. Duque back the other way for the Whitefaces. Ty across the midcourt line. Borger staying back in a bit of a zone here. Yep, in the corner now. Hayden down low, throws it away, trying to get it to Fletcher. Not a good pass. Back the other way for Borger now. Comes Jennings. Down low, Clements has it, doesn't shoot. Back outside, they shoot the three, miss the three, and the rebound belongs to Duque. 2-2 game, 6:30 left, first quarter. Quickly down the floor, Zevon, 15-footer, no good. Rebound off to Borger. Back the other way come the Bulldogs. Fernandez all the way down. Dumps it off. Ball knocked away, but Fernandez charges into Duque. 6:28 left in the quarter, tied at 2. Duque draws a charge. That's a news flash. Hereford inbounded it too quickly. Ty gets hit every time down the floor. Sometimes they call charges, sometimes they don't. 2-2 score, 6:20 left, first quarter. Duque and the Whitefaces back the other way. Diego on his right, but Ty passes back left. Now they work it in the corner to Diego. Sophomore back to Hayden. Hayden dribbles around the perimeter. Inside Duque in the lane. Back outside. Hayden now has it in the corner. Diego down inside to Fletcher, knocked away. Touch last by the Whitefaces. Well, obviously, we're trying to get it down low, but Borger did a good job inside. Ooh, got a little pushing and shoving out there on the inbounds play, but everything's okay, says the ref. Up the floor for Borger comes Jennings. Jennings gives it back to Wooden. He sets it up on the outside now. Down the lane he goes, right corner pass. Fernandez trapped over there in the right corner. Still trapped, now just throws up a shot. It's nowhere near the mark. The rebound belongs to Hereford. Clements got it, and he was going out of bounds. Cade shoved it back behind his back, trying to get it back in play, but it hit the backboard at Hereford's ball.
He couldn't do that again if he tried.
No, he couldn't. Well, he'd tell you he could, but he couldn't. 5:25 left in the quarter, tied at 2. Here's Duque in the forecourt. Right side pass. Again, Borger in a little 1-3-1 here, and the Whiteface is trying to figure out, and there's another turnover by the Whitefaces. Fletcher, though, goes down and gets it. And finally, Borger winds up with the ball, and Zevon winds up with a foul. Well, right now, the zone, we're kind of trying to force it inside. Here we go. In the ball game for the first time in four games comes Kenyon Loftus. Out comes Diego. Full court pressure by the Whitefaces. 2-2 game. Zevin mixing it up there with Jennings. Here's the inbounds pass. Borger's got it in the backcourt, and up the floor they come. Wooden with the ball. Wooden with Hayden on him. He's trapped, throws it down in the corner. Way out front. They've got an open three, but don't take it. Down the baseline, throw it off the glass and in. Great shot there by Daniels. Borger leads it 4-2. First quarter here at Whiteface Gym. Ty takes it all the way, lays it up, and misses the layup. I think Ty came so wide open, he was shocked. Borger back the other way, and Hereford gets whistled for reaching in. That's two on Zevin real quick. 4:35 left first quarter. Gonzalez has two fouls. He's going to come out. Lopez is going to replace him. So we've got two fouls, but Zevin has them both. Whiteface is trailing 4-2. Borger with the ball here in the first period. Fernandez to inbound it. He does so on the outside here. Back in the corner, they work it. Whitefaces. Backdoor pass intercepted by Fletcher. Back the other way comes Kenyon. The Whitefaces hurry down the floor. Kenyon all the way in the corner. Three-point shot by Duque. No good. Rebound Fletcher. Fletcher back up. It's in. Four all. Good. Great job by Jaden. Got the board and put it back in the bucket. 4-4. Borger back the other way. Borger in the forecourt, in the lane. Oh, me. Back outside. Down the baseline, off the glass. No good. Rebound Clements. Back inside. His shot's up. It's no good, but he's fouled. He'll shoot two with 3:53 left in the quarter. Tied at four. Foul is on Jaden. His first. Team's third. Halfway through the first quarter. Brandon Gonzalez going to come in for the Whitefaces. Clements misses the first free throw. Hayden comes out. So we've got Brandon Gonzalez, Lopez, Fletcher, Kenyon, and Ty on the floor for the Whitefaces. Clements missed them both. Rebound Fletcher. Fletcher to Lopez. Here come the Whitefaces. In the forecourt, in the left corner now. Kenyon goes down the baseline but throws it away. Borger picks up the loose ball. Fernandez back the other way, and he is traveling. The Whitefaces, great play. I'll tell you, Brandon Gonzalez, that shows nowhere in the books, and he made him turn it over. They had a breakaway bucket. Tied at four, Hereford with the ball. All right, tie up the floor now. We need to get somebody a little bit hot on the outside is what we need. Right side pass to Lopez. Lopez back out front to Brandon. High post, goes back. Left side now. Ty inside. Nice pass back outside to Ty on the baseline. He takes about a 12-footer. It's good. 6-4 Hereford. 3:17 left in the quarter. Ty almost stole the inbounds pass, but it's Borger's ball. 6-4 Hereford. 3:15 left first period. Bulldogs inbound against full court pressure. Inbound it. Trapped in the backcourt. The Bulldogs ball loose. And it is Hereford's ball, and ahead to Ty, and this time he makes the layup. 8-4 Hereford. Inbounds to Tolliver in the backcourt. Borger all, Hereford all over him. Brandon now. Borger fires it in the forecourt. Now they've got the advantage, but they don't take it. Back to the baseline they go. Force the shot. Call a foul on the Whitefaces. Shooting foul. Foul is on Lopez. 8-4 Hereford leads. 2:51 left first quarter. Two free throws for Borger's Jaden Daniels. Four fouls against the Whitefaces. Viega's going to come in after the first free throw. So is Delosier. Free throw's up and good. 8-5. Jaden out. Lopez out. The Whitefaces down by or up by three. Second chance here at the line for Borger's Jaden Daniels. 2:51 remaining. First quarter, Whiteface Gym here tonight. Big crowd on hand. And he misses this one, and the rebound belongs to Brandon Gonzalez. Back to Ty, and here comes Duque ahead to Brandon. He's going to fire it in the corner, and Kenyon shoots the three, and it's good. 11-5, Hereford by six. Inbounds now, Borger against the pressure. Whitefaces all over it. And Borger gets bailed by a foul, the fifth against the Whitefaces with 2:33 left in the quarter. Foul was on Kenyon. His first. 2:32 left in the quarter. Villegas in the backcourt now. The Whitefaces all over him. Borger gets it into the forecourt. 6-point Hereford lead. 2:22 left first quarter. Bulldogs in the corner. Shoot a long three. It's nowhere near the mark. Rebound belongs to Delosier. Duque winds up on the floor once again. Ahead to Kenyon. Kenyon inside, and he's fouled. He'll shoot two. Wow, too
good.
Late
Glad
left for the first quarter. That's the second foul against Borger. Hereford by six. Diego going to check back in here after the first free throw. Whiteface is up by six. 2:08 remaining first quarter of play. Free throw's up and good. 12-5. Well, it's good to have Loftus back out there.
You better believe it. Good 12-5. Soft touch. Yep. Confident shooter.
Up it goes, and he made them both. 13-5, Hereford. Diego has checked into the ball game. Duque gets a rest. Borger against the full court pressure. Starts up the floor. Throws long, knocked away by Delosier. Good play by Dayton there on a cross-court pass. He went up and got his hand on it. Couldn't control it, but he kept it from getting to the Borger recipient. Brooks has come in on the post for Borger. On the outside, the Bulldogs now pass it to Brooks. Give it back to Wooden. Hereford by eight. 1:47 left in the quarter. Around the perimeter. Good defense by Whitefaces. Borger back on the outside now. Good defense by Brandon Gonzalez. Down the corner. Inside, thrown away. And Diego comes up with it. Throws it ahead now to Brandon. In the lane, back outside. Kenyon for three. It's in and out. Rebound, Borger. Ooh, elbows thrown there by Borger. Down the floor come the Bulldogs, all the way down. Inside, shot up and good. No charge this time. Whitefaces Diego gets called for the foul. They make the shot. 1:14 left in the quarter. Kenyon out, Hayden back in. 13-7 score, and Brooks can make it 13-8 now as he shoots the free throw. The Whitefaces out of the original starting five. We don't have anybody but Hayden out there. Free throw's good, 13-8. Brandon Gonzalez will be out on the point now. The sophomore walks it up the floor. Across midcourt, left side pass Diego. Diego in the corner, throws it away. Well, that time we got in a little bit of a hurry, and Diego Ornelas tried to get it. He missed, and so he comes out, and Ty comes back in. Hereford by five, Borger with the ball against full court pressure. In the forecourt, Whitefaces have it trapped here, but Borger gets free, gets it to the corner, down the baseline, little runner up, and a charge on Borger. That's Diego Villegas who drew the charge that time. Borger has three fouls and two of them are charges. 13-8 Hereford. Whitefaces inbound it to Duque who gives it back to Brandon. And here we go. Brandon across midcourt. On the left side. Passes in the corner now to Hayden. 42 seconds left in the quarter. Hayden goes to the bucket. Lays it up. Won't go. Rebound Borger. Good move by Gonzalez, but it just wouldn't go. Borger with the ball, Tolliver in the backcourt. Cross midcourt, next foul's a one and one for Borger. Borger throws it outside. Again, they won't shoot the three, and a block call this time on Duque. He wound up on the floor, but instead he gets the foul, and it's a one and one for Borger. 23 seconds left in the first quarter. Official's not aware that it's a one and one. Whitefaces by five. Well, we're real aggressive, and it just depends on how this gets called, honestly. Jaden Daniels is the shooter for Borger. A good shooter, I might add. And he can cut it back to three as he shoots the one and one here. Up it goes, in it goes. 13-9. Whitefaces by four. Again, we're in the final seconds of the first quarter here at Whiteface Gym tonight. Second free throw is up. He makes them both. It's a three-point lead. Inbounds to Duque now. Tied, directing traffic as he comes up the floor. Calls the play. Works to his right, then left. Down the left corner, he gives it away to Brandon. Brandon back to Ty. Ty to the left. 13-10. Whiteface is up by three. Two free throws for Duque. Boy, Ty, nobody gets banged around quite like he does.
Nope, and it's every part. It's, yep. It's hand, his head, his knees, his ankles, everything.
The sophomore puts the first one up. It's good. 14-10. He can make it a 15-10 lead as he shoots again here with 6.7 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Hereford and Borger on the Whiteface home floor here tonight. Misses this one. Rebound off to
Hereford ball.
Hereford, yep. Borger knocked it out of bounds. 3.9 seconds left. Up by four. Whitefaces have a chance for a final shot here in the quarter. Brandon will inbound it. Inbounds it comes to Diego, and he misses the three at the buzzer. We played a quarter, 14-10. Hereford by four. We're back in 60 seconds.
Hereford's leading funeral home serving Deaf Smith County. The people of Deaf Smith County have chosen us the best funeral home for the last six straight years. We contribute this to the service that we provide to our families along with the care and compassion that is given to each family we serve. We are proud of this honor and will continue to meet the expectations of every family we are privileged to help. Hereford's only family-owned and operated funeral home. Our family serving your family.
For generations, First Bank Southwest has been there to help the working hands that have shaped this great land. Chances are we helped your father, and even his father. We understand for some a handshake is a stronger bond than a piece of paper. And even though times can be tough, folks around here are tougher. And that's why we're as proud of our Panhandle roots as you are. First Bank Southwest, moving your generation in the right direction. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Whitefaces lead by four, 14-10 after one quarter. It'll be Borger's ball. We began the second quarter. Kenyon back in there along with Ty and Brenlin, Hayden, and Jaden. Borger in the forecourt with the basketball. On the outside. Here's a three-pointer, and it's good. It's Wooden with the bucket. Technical on Borger on the, I guess the shot's going to count, 14-13. The Jennings would be the man who got the technical foul. I don't know what happened. I didn't see any of that. Did you,
either.
Coach?
No, sir.
The bucket
was definitely
good.
Away from the ball, and Borger's spending a lot of time talking to the stands.
They are.
On the stands.
They are. I don't know what's going on there, but they are spending a lot of time. Kenyon makes the first one. 15-13. He can make it 16-13, and then the Whitefaces will have the ball, and he does. So we lead by three and have the ball. That technical, instead of a one-point game, and it's back to a three-point lead, and we have a chance to widen that. Didn't the official, there wasn't any hesitation on the call.
No, there's no
on what was said or what was done, but... Whitefaces have the ball and a three-point lead. Inbounds it comes to Ty. Just underway in the second quarter here at Whiteface Field. Fletcher out on the high post, back in the corner now to Ty. Ty goes down the baseline, fires it over across the way to Lopez, back to Hayden. Hayden in the lane, jumper up, no good. Rebound off to Borger. Here come the Bulldogs back the other way now. Fernandez in the forecourt. Fernandez shot blocked in the backside by Hayden. 7:17 left in the half. Three-point Hereford lead. Oh, we got a foul?
Who called
Yes.
Technical foul on the Whitefaces. So the ball goes, Borger goes to the free throw line. I don't know. Coach Loftus talking with the official right now. The free throw is up and good, 16-14. Second chance here. He can make it a one-point game now as Daniels is the shooter. He makes them both, 16-15 now. Hayden comes out. Bad language, I don't, or what he thinks is bad language. Borger with a runner on the baseline, nowhere near the mark. Rebound off to Lopez. What a play by Lopez. He goes down the floor. Oh, no. Lopez gets, wow. Borger's ball, 16-15, Hereford leads. Lopez is going, he's driving in. And as he gets in there, they kind of converge on him. The ball winds up out of bounds. Lopez winds up on the floor. Borger winds up with the ball. One-point lead for the Whitefaces. 6:55 left first half. Bulldogs. Good defense by the Whitefaces. Daniels has it outside now. Diego has him. Daniels down in the lane. Puts it up. Misses. And there is a jump ball. Brooks and Duque. Brooks at about 6'3 or 4. Duque at about 5'6.
Ty got an elbow in the chin right then.
6:40 left in the half. Ty in the forecourt. Gets a little bit of a screen there. Passes off to Kenyon, who shoots a three, and it's no good, and the rebound belongs to Borger. Back the other way. Long pass through the hands of Brooks. Herbert's ball.
That nearly took Mr. Hedrick's head off
it
right
did.
There.
It did. If he had been like
he's
decent height.
He's stunned at the moment.
If he'd been a decent height, he'd have gotten hit. 6:26 left first half. Hereford up by one. Ty kind of slows it down as he walks across the midcourt line. Works to his left. Pulls up. Shoots an eight-footer. Winds up on the floor. Missed shot. Up and in by Fletcher on the rebound. Fletcher, that little left-handed bank shot, gives Hereford a three-point lead. In the backcourt now, Diego. Playing some good defense. Borger gets it ahead now to Wooden. 5:55 left in the half. Wooden in traffic, loses the ball, and it's stolen by the Whitefaces. Long lead pass comes to Diego. Outside to Ty. Ty back to Diego. Back to Ty in the corner. Down the baseline, little runner up, no good. Rebound, fought for. Ty gets the rebound. Left-handed shot, Ty winds up on the floor, gets it again, off to Fletcher. Fletcher goes up, he's fouled, he'll shoot two. Duque, after getting hammered and knocked to the floor, laying on his back, I thought he was gonna shoot two, but he didn't, he passed to Ty, and Ty draws a foul, and he'll shoot two. Only the sixth foul against Borger, I believe, the first half. 5:27 with the intermission, we've got 8. Three-point lead for the Whitefaces. Two free throws for Duque.
I think they're going to let.
I mean, for
yeah,
Fletcher.
Fletch.
I don't know what all this is about, but the foul was on Borger's Brooks. Free throws good by Fletcher. Makes it a four-point lead. Ty out and Brandon in. 19-15 Hereford. 5:27 left first half. See Nicola's folks over there. She signed with New Mexico Junior College to play volleyball.
Yeah.
Good for them. Missed shot. Off it comes. Whitefaces missed the follow shot. And, Lopez almost stole it again. He stole the first one. Got it back to Fletcher. Fletcher missed that shot. And then Borger winds up with the ball. Borger. Wow. Kind of out of control there. Fletch kind of put it back in his face. But it's still Borger's ball. Four-point lead for the Whitefaces. 5:12 left in the half. Inbounds to Daniels. Outside to Wood. Back in the corner. And the three-point shot's no good. Clements gets the rebound. It's no good. The rebound belongs to Fletcher. Fletcher to Brandon. Brandon in the backcourt. Throws it long ahead now to Diego. Diego off to Lopez. Down inside. Whitefaces reverse off the glass. It's good by Fletcher. 21-15, Fletch. Fletcher, I think, motioned to Brooks to come on, but I'm not sure. Full court pressure. Borger in the forecourt now. Takes the three-point shot. It's no good. Rebound off to Fletcher. Ball loose. Now Borger winds up with it and loses it. Nope, keeps it in bounds. Saved on the far side. 4:26 to the half. Borger with the ball. Hereford with a six-point lead. On the outside, it's Wooden. Right side pass goes to Daniels. Daniels tries to go in, does, passes off to Clements. Clements on the baseline, can't shoot, back outside. They shoot the three, it's no good. Rebound, oh my goodness, bodies all over the place. Another three, it's not close, wow. I'm telling you, Brandon got pushed in the back by Borger's Jaden Daniels. This thing's gonna get out of hand if they're not careful. I mean, he just shoved him that time right in the back, and that'll be 1-1. Diego Ornelas comes out. Diego Villegas comes in. Nope. Can't come in yet because
Ornelas is shooting?
Yep. Ornelas is the shooter. 21-15 Hereford. 4:04 left, first half. Whitefaces lead by six.
Deaf Smith County Hospital District helps our community senior citizens get the most out of life. Our Medicare Wellness Center provides free annual wellness visits for Medicare enrollees. Our team works with you to get up to date on screenings, immunizations, and other preventative care. Together, we review your medical history, assess your risk factors for illness, and discuss ways to reduce risks and promote health. With an annual Medicare wellness visit, you get a personalized prevention plan focused on your good health. Visit dschd.org or call 806-364-7512.
All right, back here at Whiteface Gym. 22-15, Hereford leads. We missed the second free throw, and Borger has the ball as we return to play with 4:01 left in the half. Whitefaces have had some effect with the full court pressure. Again, Borger, this thing's gotten pretty rough. Hey, it's, officials have already called a technical on each side, and cooler heads need to prevail here. Whiteface is back out. We've got Delosier now, Kenyon, Brandon, Lopez, and Villegas. That's the five on the floor for the Whitefaces. Borger with the ball, full court pressure. Again, eight fouls against the Whitefaces. Borger inbounds it in the backcourt to Wooden. Wooden with Gonzalez on him. Starts up the floor, throws it cross court. 15-footer is up, it's nowhere near the mark. Rebound goes to Brandon Gonzalez. Here come the Whitefaces. Brandon down the floor, bluffs the three. Outside to Kenyon, goes to the baseline, back to Brandon. Brandon dribbles, passes out front to Villegas. Villegas gives it off to Kenyon. Kenyon back to Lopez. Lopez in the corner now to Brandon. 3:29 till the half, Hereford up by seven. Kenyon takes a long three, and it is no good, and the rebound belongs to the Bulldogs. Bulldogs almost turned it over there. The ball's knocked away, but Borger gets it back. Fernandez in traffic, forces the shot, and makes the shot. Isaiah Fernandez didn't take a very good shot, but when he went in, it was a real good shot. Hereford by five. Kenyon to Delosier. Delosier starts up. He's fouled, and he'll shoot two. Wow. Again, a pretty rough foul. 3 minutes left, first half. Hereford by five. Dayton to the line.
Ten.
Foul was on Fernandez.
Took a long time to figure out who that was against.
Two fouls on Fernandez. We brought Jennings back into the ballgame. It was Jennings who got the technical earlier. This is a 1-1 for Dayton here. With 3 minutes left in the first half, a five-point game. Delosier puts it up, puts it in. Nice soft touch, 23-16. Duque back in, Lopez out. Six-point lead, 3 minutes left in the half. Delosier with one more chance here. 23-17. Dayton puts it up and makes them both. Good job, Delosier. Whitefaces lead by seven. Borger against the full court pressure in the backcourt. Whitefaces get the steal. Duque and Villegas. Oh, no. Oh. Diego whistle for a travel. Wow, 24-17. That was kind of a mystery travel there. Inbounds now, Borger. Cross midcourt. All the way down. Clements has it. Shoot, throw it outside for a three. It's no good. Borger inside. Shot no good. Again, bodies all over the floor. Lead pass now ahead to Diego. He goes to the bucket, misses the shot. Rebound Borger. And the Bulldogs in the backcourt. Ball still loose. And out of the pack, Borger gets it. Then down the floor. Timeout call by Borger with 2:24 left in the half and Hereford leading by seven. We're back in 30 seconds.
Needing extra income? Looking for a full-time job with advancement opportunities? McDonald's in Hereford is hiring full-time and part-time people who are energetic and customer-focused. At McDonald's, you will be able to work flexible hours, whether it's 3 hours or 8 hours per day. Benefits include a free meal when you're working and a 30% discount when you're off-duty. Earn a vacation benefit and $10 an hour and above with experience. To apply, just text TX162 to 38000.
All right, it's 2:24 till the half. 24-17, Hereford leads. A game that is pretty rough and tumble.
It is full contact.
Yeah.
Not no contact.
It is. Borger inbounds it now. In the forecourt, around the perimeter. Down inside, bluff to three. And finally cross court, Clements. Clements in traffic. Brings it back outside. Baseline jumper up and an air ball. The rebound belongs to Clements. Back outside, Borger will go again. Oh, my. Oh, my gosh. Borger finally gets whistled for a charge. That's Fernandez.
His third.
His third knocked Kenyon to the floor after traveling. So we'll take that one instead. The Whitefaces bring Hayden back in. He inbounds it to Duque, and here we go. 7-point Hereford lead, a minute 53 left till the half. Duque across midcourt. Left side pass goes to Diego. Down low to Delosier. Delosier back outside. Duque for three from the top of the circle. It's good. 27-17. Hereford by 10. Minute 38 left first half. Whistle and a foul.
Yeah.
Brandon, another technical on the Whitefaces. So two free throws from Borger. First one's no good. Still a 10-point Hereford lead. 1:36 left in the half. Second free throw goes up, and he missed them both. So, technical on the Whitefaces winds up not costing the Whitefaces. Again, I mean, I don't know. That's twice now. That was for running his mouth. That's what the official said, so I don't know. Inbounds now. Borger's got it in the forecourt, trailing by 10. A minute 30 left first half. Clements outside. Can't shoot. Passes back. In the left corner, three-point shot, no good, but a foul on the Whitefaces. I think Lopez is going to be, yep, whistle for the foul. So three free throws now for Borger. Trailing by 10, 1:23 left, first half. It'll be Wooden at the free throw line for Borger. Free throw is up, it's good, 27-18. He's got two more. We're at Whiteface Gym tonight again. This is not a must win, but a must win for the Whitefaces. He's made the first two, makes it 28-27-19. I'm just afraid this game, something's going to happen bad, I'm afraid.
You got that feeling.
Makes all three, yep. Makes all three free throws. It's 27-20, Hereford. 1:20 left in the half. Duque across midcourt. Gives it off now to Hayden. Hayden fires it over here to Diego down in the corner to Duque. Duque is fouled. The foul is on Jennings. That's 10 against Borger, so it's a two-shot foul here for Ty. Hereford leading by 7. 1:10 left in the first half. 27-20 Whiteface lead. As Ty steps to the free throw line. Now Borger, I don't know what they're doing. They don't either. Ty's ready to shoot now as the official hands him the ball. Three dribbles, puts it up, and it is good. 28-20, Whitefaces by 8, 1:10 left in the half. Daniels back in the ball game for Borger. Ty with a second chance here now.
That's three takes in one half.
Makes them both, 29-20. Hereford up by 9 in the backcourt. Wooden has the ball. Wooden, midcourt, throws it ahead. Oh, they almost threw it away, and in traffic, throw it in the corner, fire it back out. He, nope, doesn't take the three. Now he does. Bad shot. Rebound off to... Foul on Duque. His second. 51 seconds left in the half. Ty trying to get the rebound. Honestly, the officials blocked me out. I did not see what happened there, but Kenyon's going to come in. Shooting two for Borger is Tolliver, and he misses the first one. Kenyon in, Ty out. 29-20, Hereford lead. Fouls aplenty here, but contact even more. Second free throw is good. Hereford by 8. 51 seconds left in the half. Lopez gives it away to Kenyon. The Whiteface is going to set up. Left side pass now to Hayden. 39 seconds left in the half. Kenyon in the corner. Steps back, shoots the three, and makes it. 32-21. Hereford by 11 with 32 seconds left in the half. And the Whitefaces take a timeout. We're back in 30 seconds.
First Financial Bank knows how important a person's vehicle can be.
My SUV is perfect for taking clients to properties and me to the golf course.
My pickup hauls work supplies all week and the family on weekends.
My hybrid helps the environment and my fuel bill.
If you're ready for a new vehicle, talk to First Financial. We offer loans at competitive rates with fast local approval.
My 4x4 works hard, but plays even harder.
First Financial Bank, you first. Member FDIC.
All right, 32 seconds left in the half. Hereford with an 11-point lead. Borger with the basketball. Kenyon with his second three of the first half, I believe. White faces full court pressure. Borger, oh. In the backcourt now. White faces trap it, but Borger gets it ahead. Back in the corner, they shoot the three. It's nowhere near the mark. Wow. Inside a push that doesn't get called, and Clements with a nice bucket off the board. It's a 9-point lead. Ahead quickly now. The White faces with 9 seconds left. Plenty of time. Diego to the bucket, off the glass, too firm. Borger with the ball, 2 seconds. And from midcourt, Borger throws up a wing and a prayer. The Whitefaces lead by 9 as the first half draws to a close. And the two teams head to the locker room. Things need to calm down just
a little bit.
Just a little bit.
It feels like it could
it
blow,
does.
Doesn't it?
It does indeed. Whitefaces lead by 9 at the intermission. Let's take a 2-minute timeout. We'll be back at Whiteface Gym.
Diversity reigns at Hereford High School, and we respect the individuality of every student. Our primary goal as caretakers of youth is to instill a sense of academic and civic responsibility in each young mind that passes through these halls, inspiring a lifetime of future success.
Hereford High School, the best choice in public education. 1,100 students strong. Highly qualified staff, state and national award-winning programs. Follow us at HHS Pride on Instagram. Hereford ISD, committed to children, dedicated to excellence.
The brightest star in the Lone Star State, Stevens 5-Star Car and Truck Center. One price selling makes it easy to buy. You get 5-star treatment, we treat you great. With stars and great selection, the quality and value too. Stevens does it all for you. You get 5-star treatment every day. Stevens 5-Star Car and Truck Center.
It seems like everyone is looking to save a little money these days. Simple tasks around your home, like lowering the blinds, switching to LED light bulbs, and monitoring the temperature on your thermostat, can rack up big savings on your power bill. We even offer a budget billing plan to help level out your bill throughout the year. Call us at 806-364-1166 for questions or to sign up for budget billing. Deaf Smith Electric Co-op, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Whatever your type of home, experience a new level of home comfort with the new Bryant Evolution system. When installed with the Evolution Connects control, this advanced system can communicate with both your indoor and outdoor units for increased comfort and efficiency. Ask your Bryant dealer about an Evolution heating and cooling system today.
Call Bob's Heating and Air at 364-1195, your local factory-authorized Bryant dealer.
All right, it's halftime. The boys' game, 32-23. The Whitefaces lead by 9 in what has been a wrestling match for the first 16 minutes, but we have the lead. Right here with us now is Coach Lisa Taylor, who, well, you just had them all the way, didn't you, Coach?
I'm not sure. I was beginning to get a little nervous.
Down by 7 with about, I think, 2:37 left to play. Aubrey hit a 3 that was huge, and then Rodriguez made a great bucket on a little pump fake that she banked in. And then we held on to win 49-48, and it was a huge game for us, Coach. I mean, to get to 6-3.
It was, and, you know, I think that if we would have lost this one, it would have been a hard time to stay in the playoff run.
I would agree. We go to Pampa now Tuesday night, but talk a little bit. I mean, we just struggled all night long. We never could find a rhythm, but we did. And how do you stay with it like that?
Well, I think I contribute part of it, and I'm not blaming the officials by any means, but I felt like that the officiating was a little bit tighter than what we've seen in the last few games, and it was hard for us to get into any kind of rhythm just because, you know, different kinds of fouls were being called, and we weren't able to adjust like we normally have been able to. So I think that kept us off in the first half. And we missed some easy baskets, you know. That was, we were missing baskets and not controlling the boards, and that was, you know, our downfall in the first half.
Loftus really hurt us. She was so strong inside, and they got it to her down low. I mean, it was hard for us to either keep her from scoring or fouling her, one of the two.
You know, we got lucky with her on the free throw line tonight, because last time we played them, she was money on the free throw line. Yeah. So,
and Briscoe missed a couple late there that were would have given them the lead again. So
the basketball gods were looking at
they were,
at us,
they looked after us. But you take what you can get, and we're 6-3 now. We go to Pampa, as I said, Tuesday night, and back here next Friday night. But we need all the wins we can get going down that stretch run.
You know, Pampa's going to be tough. I mean, they beat us here at our place. Yeah. I felt like we were really tight against them. We're going to have to shoot the ball better because they play that extended 2-3 zone, and we need to knock down some outside shots. But, you know, they came up and beat West Plains in a big win on Tuesday, so which helped our cause.
Yeah, I was starting to say that kind of put us in a better spot there. Mm-hmm. But here we go now with and Bartlett, the first time we play.
Delia showed me some resiliency tonight. She did a phenomenal job on Briscoe tonight. So, you know, I may give her another look at it on with Bartlett, because I think she's kind of figured some things out. But, you know, we'll try whoever we have and just try to contain her and shut everybody else down. So,
well, with the district, that Borger drops to 3-6 tonight with a loss. So they're kind of in a bit of a bind. But us, West Plains, and Pampa are probably locked in for two out of three.
Right.
Talk a little bit about, you know, what's happened with us, how we've gotten better, the things that you're proudest of, I guess, at this point.
I think that, you know, we're finally trusting the process. We had a really hard time of trusting that our teammates had our back on those kids that drive. You know, we've got Briscoe at, here at Borger, and then, you know, the Bartlett girl at Tampa. Right. Dumas has one, and that little number one, the Cameron Cox girl. Every team has one kid that just goes to the basket all the time, and that's been our nemesis. And so we've really worked on it. And when, you know, when they get, we're so afraid of getting beat.
Yeah.
And I think that that's our problem. We don't trust the team behind us. And so that's what we've been preaching for a week now, Sadie.
Yeah.
You know, Sanchez at Randall.
Yeah. She's pretty good.
She's going to beat you guys. Yeah. You know, she's going to – that's – we know that. But don't dwell on that. Keep her from shooting the three. You've got teammates that are going to help you out on the bottom.
Well, it was a great win tonight. An unlikely one, I thought, late. But we got it done, and that's all that matters.
Yes. We'll celebrate tonight and get to work in the morning.
All right, Coach Tedder. Congratulations.
Thank
you. Great job. White Lady Whiteface is winning 49-48. Okay, in the earlier game tonight, the Whiteface guys up by 9 here at the intermission. We're going to take another 60-second break, and we'll be back courtside in 1 minute.
As the new year unfolds, new projects are born. If you are interested or have any questions regarding a consumer or commercial loan, First National Bank of Hereford can assist you. You will be working with Hereford's only locally owned bank. Applying is easy with our online consumer application, or visit any of our locations to apply for your personal or business needs. First National Bank of Hereford and Friona Banking Center. We have roots where others have branches. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Are you tired of arguing with your children about screen time? WTRT and WT Services can help. You can enforce the limits you've set in your home with Experience IQ from WTRT and WT Services. You can schedule when the internet is turned off to make sure bedtime is screen-free. You automate screen time for your children by adding Experience IQ to the WT Smart Home app. Download the app today.
All right, back here at Whiteface Gym, 32-23. Hereford on top here at the half. Two teams coming back out, and we're just minutes away from the start of the second half as the Whiteface guys try to go to 4-3 as they end the first round of district play. And again, the ladies now 6-3 in the league as they finished. We've got five games remaining after tonight against Pampa and Dumas and West Plains and Randall and Canyon. That's what remains for Coach Taylor's crew. Again, a big crowd here tonight, and glad they've come out to the gym here. We don't, girls just have, let's see, what do we got? We've got Dumas left here at home and Randall.
Randall,
that's it for the girls. Wow. The guys with one more in addition to that as they got Perryton here two games after the girls. What's the first half score in here, Coach?
For the Whitefaces, 10 points apiece for both Kenyon Loftus and Ty Duque. 7 points for Jaden Fletcher, and got a bucket for Zevin Gonzalez. Got two free throws for DeLozier. For Porter, 7 points from Jaden Daniels, 6 points from Wooden, and 4 points, I guess, next line from Clements.
Okay.
So, 10 of 16 from free throw, Borger free throws the first half, 11 for 14 are the Whitefaces, so pretty even on that.
Yeah. Three fouls on Fernandez for Borger, and a couple of players, Brooks and Moreno, with two. And then on the Whiteface end, we've got three with two, Zevin and Ty and Breland all have two fouls. Here we go, up by 9, second half about to begin. It'll be Borger's ball as we begin the second half. Ty, Kenyon, Zayden, Zevin, and Fletcher. Borger inbounds it, and here we go. Fernandez will inbound it to Wooden. Wooden brings it in the forecourt. Fernandez has got it, but nothing there, and he brings it, or Daniels. Fernandez, I'm sorry, back out front now to Tolliver. Here's a jumper from 15 feet. It's no good. Rebound off to Fletch. Fletch to Hayden. Hayden across midcourt. Gives it off to Duque. Duque drives down the lane. Turns, jumps, shoots, and misses. But Fletcher gets the rebound, puts it back up. And Fletcher kind of got banged around there, but no foul. Back the other way comes Borger. In the corner now, the Bulldogs. Trapped. Pass it off, shoot a three. It's no good. Rebound Fletcher. Fletcher's outlet pass to Hayden, and here come the Whitefaces. Hayden ahead to Kenyon for three. It's no good. Rebound off to Borger. We played a minute. Nobody scored here in the second half. Hereford going for the steal in the backcourt. Got a foul instead, I think. Yep. Foul on
Jennings.
I don't know. Yep, I think it was. I do. It was on Borger. Yep, his third. Inbounds now. Hayden back out front. Seven for three. It's no good. He goes and gets the rebound. Fletcher now has it down on the floor. Still loose. Fletcher gets it out to Kenyon. Kenyon out to Duque. Inside Fletch. Turnaround jumper. He traveled. 32-23 Hereford. 6:45 remaining third quarter. Bulldogs with the ball in the backcourt as both teams a little slow out of the blocks here in the second half. Inbounds from Borger. It comes to Tolliver. He's trapped. He throws it away. Back it comes to Kenyon. Off the glass and in. Steal by Duque. Bucket by Loftus. Hereford by 11. Again, the Whitefaces with full court pressure. Borger now going to sub. 34-23 Hereford. Coach Loftus with a question for the official. Official comes over to talk with him. I don't know what that was about. Well, I don't know. Borger's ball, Hereford by 11, 6:34 left, third quarter. The Bulldogs will inbound it underneath their bucket. And the Whitefaces with full court pressure. Inbounds, it comes to no one, and no one's made the call. I guess it's going to be Borger's ball. Hereford knocked it out of bounds. Borger inbounding the ball in the backcourt again. Tough pressure by the Whitefaces. Bulldogs now inbounded this time to Daniels. Daniels comes across midcourt. In traffic, Daniels forces and misses the shot. Jaden gets the rebound. Loftus has it, and Loftus is fouled by Tolliver. 6:20 left, third period. Tolliver with the foul. That'll be his fourth. Hereford up by 11 with the ball in the backcourt. Borgers. They do. They look up in the stands. They just look up in the stands. They're their stands all the while. I don't know what's going on, but I guess some assistant coaches are housed in the stands. Here comes Duque up the floor now. 6:15 left, third period. Hereford up by 11. Tie out on the point. Off to Hayden. Down low to Jaden. Shoots. He can't get it. Rebound to Clements. Clements passes back in the backcourt. 6 minutes left, third period. Wooden walks it up the court for the Bulldogs. Wooden double-teamed and trapped. The ball's loose and comes to Duque, and Duque is fouled by Daniel. Wow. Yeah. 5:53 left, third period. Hereford up by 11. The Borger player, what Coach Loftus was saying, and the Borger player was, he was mouthing to the official from the moment the call was made, but it is Hereford's ball right in front of us. With an 11-point lead. Borger's got six players on the floor. Somebody's going to have to come out. Kenyon inbounds it now. Gets the return pass. Loses the ball. Borger back the other way. Down the floor they come. Daniels in the lane. Passes back outside. Jumper in the lane is up and no good. Rebound Fletcher. Fletcher to Duque. Duque quickly down the floor, and I do mean quickly. Off to Zevin. Zevin inside. Baseline pass to Duque. Back out to Zevin. 5:27 left, third period. 11-point Hereford lead. What a move by Gonzalez, but the shot won't go. Saved inbounds by Duque and comes back to Kenyon. Kenyon in the lane. Can't shoot. Back out to Zevin. Zevin to the bucket, lays it off the glass. It's no good. Fletcher gets the rebound. I think Clements is going to get the foul. Yep, Clements kind of backed under him. He holds his hands out now. Cade. 5:06 left, third period. The Whitefaces lead by 11. We're back in 30 seconds.
Happy State Bank is more than just a financial institution. We're a mainstay in the lives of the customers we serve and the communities we live in. We put our customers first, making sure each experience at Happy is a great one, while taking care of all their banking needs. We pride ourselves on giving back to our local community. We partner with organizations that do the same. Happy State Bank, we're always banking with you in mind. Find out more about joining us at happybank.com. Happy State Bank, a division of Centennial Bank, member FDIC.
Well, the Whitefaces have the lead, 34-23, in what has been a sloppy third quarter, I'd say, so far.
I would say a little bit sloppy, yep. Indeed. Good news
a little
is
bit physical.
Whitefaces have an 11-point lead.
Yep.
And we just don't need it to get closer.
No.
We don't.
And we don't need it to get any rougher.
Nope.
I mean, we've got a lot of pushing and shoving going on. I mean, every play, there's somebody shooting across the gym. But on we go here as Zevin gets ready to put it in play. Out comes Fletcher now, down low. Zevin inbounds it to Fletcher in the corner, back out to Duque. Duque in the corner to Kenyon. We've got a whistle. Offensive foul on the Whitefaces on the moving screen on Fletcher, his second. 5 minutes left, third period. Borger inbounds the ball. This is Wooden in the backcourt. He throws it long in the forecourt to Brooks, who throws it ahead down on the baseline. Bulldogs back outside. Now to the bucket. Great play by Fletcher. Perfect long pass inside to Duque, off the glass and in. 36-23 Hereford, 4:38 left, third period. Borger quickly across midcourt now in the forecourt. Forces a shot again and misses. The rebound belongs to Hereford. Diego back in. Well, Borger just gets in such a hurry, and that time they took a really bad shot. 4:27 left, third period. Whitefaces have a 13-point lead, and Ty walks it up the floor. Across midcourt now, passes left side to Diego Ornelas. Out on the high post to Fletcher. Right side, down baseline to Hayden. Hayden whistle for an offensive foul. Hayden and Cade Clements that time, mixing it up down low. 13-point lead for the Whitefaces. Borger with the ball, halfway through just about the third quarter. In the backcourt now. Wooden pushes off, throws long to Clements. Clements in the lane, off the glass, and got it. 36-25. Inbounds now to Duque with 3:55 left, third quarter. Tie up the court. Cross midcourt now. Sets up the offense. Passes on the left side to Zevin. Outside to Hayden. Hayden gives it to Diego. Diego back to Ty. 3:38 left, third period. Ty back to Zevin. 36-25 Hereford. High post now Fletcher. Fletcher back to Hayden. Hayden down low. Oh, my goodness. Underneath that time on Moreno. And guess who wound up on the floor again? Ty Duque. Hereford by 11 with the ball underneath their own bucket. Diego ready to put it in play. Does so to Zevin. He shoots a three. He misses. The rebound belongs to Borger. And the ball is taken away by the Whitefaces, but they're going to, oh, my goodness. Oh. See what we got here now. There was a collision here at midfloor. Foul was called on the Whitefaces. Foul was on Hayden, and the technical foul is going to be called on Hayden. 3:20 left to play. Hereford leading by 11, but Borger's got the ball, and they'll get two free throws. And again, this is just a little bit too much contact. Whitefaces now. Free throw is up and good by Borger. That's Wooden shooting, and he makes it a 10-point game, 35-20, 36-26. Delosier's going to check in for the Whitefaces after this free throw. Then Borger will have the ball. He missed this one. It's a 10-point lead. Borger ball. That's four fouls against Hayden Gonzalez. 3:20 left, 36-26. Hereford on top. Borger with the ball in the forecourt. Fernandez to inbound it on the far side. Does so. The ball's knocked away by Duque, but he knocked it out of bounds. Borger inbounded again. Borger's Wooden and Duque mixing it up. Borger throws it in, throws it away. Saves it in the corner. Nope, they don't. Hereford's ball. Whitefaces get the turnover with the full court pressure and have it back with a 10-point lead. Tie up the floor. 36-26 Hereford. Cross midcourt. Left side pass to Lopez. Back outside to Ornelas. Right side to Ty. Ty goes down low. And he's fouled by Clements. I think that's six on Borger in this quarter. Yep, 3 minutes left, third quarter. Hereford's got four. Clements' second foul. Hereford with the ball. Inbounds to Duque. He's open for a three but doesn't take it. Passes down low, but it's intercepted by Borger. They've got Fernandez behind everyone. He lays it off the glass and in. 8-point lead now. It's Borger behind the Whitefaces. Here's Ornelas. 2:42 left third period. Ornelas to the bucket. Passes inside, shot blocked, ball back to the Whitefaces. Duque, three, it's no good. Rebound off to Ornelas, back to Duque. In traffic, he passes back outside. No good for Zevin. Whitefaces missed three shots there. Borger up the floor quickly. Ball knocked away by Lopez in the backside. Ahead to Zevin, off the glass and in, 38-28. 2:10 left third period. Borger inbounds in the backcourt now to Wooden. Wooden starts up the floor in midcourt, and Duque gets whistled for the foul. Wow. Well, Wooden got away with one that time. He pushed off. The foul went Borger's way. That's three on tie. 2 minutes left, third period. Hereford up by 10. Inbounds to Brooks now for the Bulldogs. Outside, he brings it to Wooden. Brandon Gonzalez will come in on the next whistle for Duque, I'm sure. To the bucket, shot up and good. Foul on the Whitefaces. That was Daniels. The Whitefaces let him get inside. The foul is on Whitefaces sub in now, 38-30. Foul was on Lopez. He's got three. 1:48 left third period. It's still an 8-point game. Borger hanging in here. Daniels to shoot the free throw, and he makes it. 38-31, Hereford by seven. 1:45 left third period. Lopez across midcourt. Right side pass now to Ornelas. Ornelas around to Brandon. Brandon takes it in the lane. He doesn't shoot. Back to Lopez. Lopez scoops it off the glass. Nice move. 40-31, a minute 30 left third period. Borger in the backcourt. Fires it in the corner. Clements has it. Takes it down the lane. Loses the ball. Ornelas comes up with it. Back to Lopez. A minute 15 left third period. Lopez in the corner now to Brandon. Back out to Lopez. He's open for a three. It's no good. Rebound inside Brandon. It's up and in. 42-31. Brandon Gonzalez with the putback. Minute left, third period. In the backcourt, Borger with the ball. Against the pressure. Both teams with six fouls here in this quarter. Quickly in the forecourt now. Borger trapped, ball loose, travel on Borger. 48 seconds left, third period. Hereford up by 11, gets it back. Whiteface is ready to inbound it in the backcourt now. I don't know. That was three fouls. I don't know how many fouls. That wasn't a foul. That was a travel. Clements comes out of the ball game for Borger. Diego! Borger now trying to sub somebody in late. He doesn't get here. 45 seconds left in the period. Diego outside. Zevin on the left side in the corner. Brandon doesn't take the shot. Back to Zevin. Back to Lopez. In the corner, Brandon takes the three. Makes the three. 45-31. That guy can shoot the basketball. Hereford by 14. 24 seconds left, third period. Borger in the backcourt. Hereford carrying the ball. Borger. Daniels got under it. Everybody wants the official to explain the call to them, too. 18 seconds left in the period.
And I don't think they have to explain it to anyone.
I don't think they do either. Here's Brandon in the backcourt against pressure from Fernandez. Comes in the forecourt. Wow, Fernandez. Brandon passes off to DeLozier. Back outside now. Zevin off to Brandon from the free throw line. It is up and good. 47-31. That's the end of the third quarter. The Whitefaces lead it by 16. We'll take a 60-second break and be right back.
When life's unexpected moments happen, you can rest easy knowing Prairie Insurance is on your side. Prairie Insurance will listen to you and help tailor a policy to meet your needs. They offer multiple insurance products, including home, auto, business, and farm insurance, with the knowledge to make sure you're covered. Give them a call at 363-6489 or stop by their office at 213 West Park Avenue. When you're ready to have peace of mind regarding the things that matter most, call Prairie Insurance at 363-6489 or stop by 213 West Park Avenue and they'll make sure you're covered.
One of the most difficult things we experience in life is losing a loved one. So when that time comes, please make sure you place your loved one in the hands of people that truly care about your family and the service that your family deserves when experiencing loss. There is nothing more important at that time, so allow Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home to take care of those needs with the utmost respect for you and your family. Hereford's only family-owned and operated funeral home. Our family serving your family.
All right, 16-point Hereford lead as we go to the final quarter. Nice little surge there at the end of the quarter, Coach.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Brandon Gonzalez came yep. on 5, 6, 7 points there in quarter number three at the end of quarter three.
He inbounds the ball now to Lopez. We've got Zevin and Dayton and Diego Arnalis. Diego outside. Here's Lopez on the right side, down low to Zevin. Turnaround jumper up and good. 49-31. Again, in the backcourt, Hernandez ahead to midcourt now with a pass and a hand check called on Brandon. That's the seventh foul. Comes with 7:36 to play. 18 points, the lead for the Whitefaces. 1-1 opportunity here for Jaden Daniels as he steps to the line for the Bulldogs. It's a good free throw shooter, as we've seen earlier tonight. Up it goes, and it's no good. Rebound off to Arnalis. Here comes Diego down the floor in the corner. Brandon for three. Brandon in and out. Rebound Clements. Back the other way. He goes midcourt. Ball stolen by Brandon. Throws it up and in. 51-31, a 20-point Hereford lead. Brandon Gonzalez putting on a show here. In the backcourt, Borger now. Trapped again. Throws it away and saved at midcourt by the Bulldogs' Fernandez. He's trapped, gets free, throws down low, ball loose. Clements picks it up, misses. Rebound fought for. Shot blocked by DeLozier. Rebound off to Diego. Here come the Whitefaces. Diego all the way. Reverse layup. It won't go, but he's fouled. Oh, they caught goaltending? Is that what he did? He called goaltending.
He did indeed.
53-31 for Diego. Congratulations. Timeout Borger with 6:46 to play. Hereford up 22. We're back in 30 seconds.
Heard athletes work tirelessly on the fundamentals of their particular sport while learning to work in a team concept. It's not much different at Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union. Our employees have a dedication to serve our members daily with the fundamentals of good business. Being friendly and helping give you peace of mind and knowing that when you need banking assistance, you can get it from our knowledgeable staff. Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, member NCUA,
working as a team since 1936 with our members. Go Herd!
...53-31, the Whitefaces in control here in the fourth quarter against the visitors from Borger. The win tonight will put Hereford 4-3 after the first round of play. Again, going to Pampa on Tuesday night and back here next Friday night against Dumas. That's what's in store in the immediate future for the Whiteface guys. Delosier, Zevin, Breland, Brandon, and Diego Ornelas. That's the five on the floor for Coach Loftus and the Whitefaces. 53-31, 6:46 is what the scoreboard shows. As Borger inbounds the ball. Daniels has got it. They get it quickly to the forecourt. Knocked away, taken away by Lopez. Lopez ahead now to Brandon. Brandon pulls up, takes a 10-footer. It's no good. Rebound fought far. Borger comes out of there with it. They've got a man behind everyone. Get it ahead to Fernandez, and he puts it in. 53-33. The Whitefaces by 20. 6:26 left. We're not going to let up. In the corner now, Lopez spins in the lane. Passes back out. Zevin for three. Zevin, no good. Goes after the rebound, and it's out of bounds off of Hereford, I believe. Yep. 20-point lead, 6:12 to play. Viegas, Loftus, Fletcher, and Duque back in for the Whitefaces. Quickly up the floor this time, breaks the press. He carries the ball again. They don't call it. Set it up on the outside. Daniels does. 6 minutes left in the ball game. Daniels in the lane, misses the shot. Rebound, Brooks outside Fernandez for three. It's no good. Rebound, Diego Viegas. Diego throws it long ahead now to Duque, who goes to the bucket, passes back in the corner. Three-point shot, no good. District win, their 17th overall win of the season. And now ready to put it in play against full court pressure is Kenyon. Inbounds it to Duque. Duque with Moreno on him starts up the floor. Tie goes right, then left. Back left now and gives it away to Kenyon. Kenyon open. Nope, he's just going to drive and fire it to the corner. We shoot the three and it's good. That was. Is now with the foul. 56-33 Hereford, 5:07 to play. Good to see Nick get in there and hit him a three.
There ain't nothing more fun than that,
no,
is it?
There's not.
Get up off the bench and immediately go score.
5:07 left to play. The Whiteface is up 56-33. Won the girls game 49-48. The shooter for the Bulldogs is Tolliver, and he makes the first, 56-34. It's a 22-point lead for the Whitefaces. Lady Whitefaces 6-3 now in the district. The boys will be 4-3 after five more minutes passes. Tolliver makes them both. It's 56-35. Borger with full court pressure. And they foul Duque. We'll go at the other end. That's seven against Borger. He'll shoot the 1-1 with 5:05 left. Tie foul by Fernandez that time. And for Fernandez, that is his fourth.
That is his fourth.
His fourth, okay. I thought he was going out. I thought he acted like he thought he had fouled out, but it was only his fourth. So Ty steps to the line now to shoot 1-1 with his team leading by 21. He puts it up, and it's good. 57-35. Whitefaces by 22. Again, we just need to play this thing out and everybody stay nice and safe. And Ty makes them both, 58-35. Inbounds in the backcourt. Full court pressure continues from the Whitefaces. Borger. Moreno in the backcourt. And he's charging in to tie. With 4:55 left, Hereford gets it back. Moreno not believing it. 23-point lead for the Whitefaces. Inbounds now. Kenyon throws it back out to Diego, who spins back to Kenyon. He shoots a three. It's no good. The rebound belongs to Borger. 4:44 left. Here come the Bulldogs, down by 23. On the right side, don't take the shot. Lost the ball, got it back. Pass back out front. Left side three is up. It's no good. Rebound off to Kenyon, and he's fouled by Moreno. .426 to play. He comes down to shake Coach Loftus' hand and goes to the bench. Clements back in for the Bulldogs. Kenyon Loftus is the shooter. Again, back in action for the first time since the West Plains game, which was, I believe this is four games ago. Kenyon makes it 59-35. Second chance now for Loftus. Whitefaces makes them both, 60-35. Borger inbounds again. Whitefaces still full court pressure. Up the floor now, Borger. Got a two-on-one, pulls up and shoots the three, and it's good. Bucket by Daniels makes it 60-38. Whitefaces trapped in the backcourt. Now Kenyon at midcourt, fires it ahead to Duque. Ty goes around to his left. They try to double-team him, but can't. Back to Ty. He throws it back outside to Kenyon. Left side now. Down. Oh, threw it away. Trying to get it inside to Fletcher. Diego Villegas was, and didn't make a good pass. Borger in the forecourt with 3:51 left. Tolliver out front. Over to Daniels. Daniels gets a little bit of a screen. Pulls up. Can't shoot. Dribbles back toward midcourt. Daniels back right and then left. 3:35 to play. Tolliver in the lane. Throws it up. The foul's going to be on Fletcher, I believe.
Fletcher's like, dude, I was just standing there.
Two shots for Tolliver. 60-38. The Whitefaces with a 22-point lead. Delosier, Lopez, Zevin, Diego, and Brandon coming back in. First free throw was good. Here come all the subs now. Whitefaces with a 21-point lead, 3:31 left. The issue has been decided, just what the margin will be here on a big crowd, Whiteface Gym. Both free throws good by Tolliver. And it's 60-40. Full court pressure by Borger. Brandon throws it ahead now to Lopez. He goes to the bucket, puts it off the glass. 62-40. Boy, Lopez is quick. 22-point lead. Borger in the backcourt. Whitefaces trying to get the trap, but they don't. Borger gets it in the forecourt. Clements has it on the left side, passes back to the top of the circle. Off on the right side to Daniels now. Daniels with Bernalis on him, goes in the lane, loses the ball, gets it back. Clements baseline jumper, it's no good. Rebound off to Brandon Gonzalez. 2:52 to play. Brandon's fouled, I think.
Did he call a foul?
I think he called, I don't know what he called. Kicking the ball, I guess. I don't know. Hereford's ball. Brandon ready to put it in play. We'll do so to Zevin. Zevin gets it ahead now to Diego. Off it goes to Lopez. Reverse layup. 64-40. How do you like them apples? Lopez under the bucket just reversed it. Wow. Borger in the forecourt. Ball loose. Hereford's got it. Brandon Gonzalez. Here he goes to the bucket. Left-handed layup is good. 66-40. 2:24 to play. Borger in the backcourt. Up the floor. Through the full court pressure. Underneath and a foul on the Whitefaces. Be two shots for Borger.
Hold it on Brandon.
Brandon, his second, third. How many points has Brandon got?
I thought I just had him down as two. Brandon has got 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 tonight so far.
Great job. All those coming here in the late third quarter, fourth quarter. Free throw is good by Wooden, makes it 66-41. Whiteface is going to win two here tonight. One, the girls just by their chinny chin chin there, and win the boys by a comfortable margin. Both free throws are good. Brandon's got it. Here he comes in the forecourt, in the corner. Diego with the ball back out front. It goes now to Lopez. He drives and just puts a little floater up and in. 68-42. Breland Lopez putting on a show, too. Here's Borgers, Tolliver all the way. Tolliver lost it and traveled and knocked it out of bounds. He can't get it. Ball's out of bounds off of.
There's a T.
Bulldog. That was Burley. So Burley, after the ball went out of bounds off him, we're conversing here with Jaden and Diego and Duque. Here's Brandon will shoot. Randall will shoot the two free throws. 1:34 to play. It'll be Hereford ball after the free throw. Now we got the officials conversing here. I don't know. What the hell that was about. Let's see if we can listen in here. He was disqualified. I don't know what he said, but the official said he was disqualified, so. Free throw is good by Brandon. 69-42, Hereford on top of the Bulldogs. 70-42. Oh, okay, the foul. That was the call. Now he's shooting two more, I guess. Or I don't know if they call two technicals, maybe.
Maybe so. Maybe that's why he's
ejected. That's why he's disqualified. I don't know. 71-42. Oh, he missed. Made 3 out of 4. Brandon's upset. Whiteface's sub in now. Torres and Jaden, Kenyon, Duque, and Diego. 1:34 left. We're up by 29. Hereford's ball. Timeout call by Borger with 1:34 to play. We'll take a 30-second break and be right back.
Hereford athletes work tirelessly on the fundamentals of their particular sport while learning to work in a team concept. It's not much different at Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union. Our employees have a dedication to serve our members daily with the fundamentals of good business. Being friendly and helping give you peace of mind for knowing that when you need banking assistance, you can get it from our knowledgeable staff. Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, member NCUA, working as a team since 1936 with our members. Go Herd!
All right, we're at Whiteface Gym. They did call two technicals on Burley, and he got ejected as a result of that. Whiteface cheerleaders are out doing those handstands and all, which I don't know, Coach. I wouldn't be very good.
That bird is scary up there, isn't it?
Ooh. Of course, they couldn't get me up there, so I'd be
You'd be the base all the time.
I'd be the base.
That's really the only cheerleader term I know.
Hereford's ball. We have a minute and 34 seconds left, and the Whitefaces obviously are going to win the game. We just need this thing to end kind of peacefully here. Inbounds, it comes to Torres. Nick's got it on the far side. He passes out front. Herbert throws it away. Now it's taken back away by Duque, but he stepped out of bounds. 1:26 left. Borger's ball down by 29. Whiteface Gym. 4-3 in the district are the Whitefaces. Lady Whitefaces are 6-3. Little lob in deep. Whitefaces collapse, but the shot's up and good. The Bulldogs, that's Brooks. Inbounds to Kenyon, back to Duque. 1:13 left. Duque down the floor, off to Diego. Villegas back out front now to Kenyon. 1:05 left in the ballgame. Duque's got it in the right corner. Ty holds it, passes back out front to Torres. 1 minute to play.
Run it off.
71-44 Hereford. Outside to Fletcher. Fletcher going to give it back to Duque, down to 49 seconds. He hands it off. Diego gives to Fletcher. We're down to 35 seconds. We're trying to eat up the clock here, boys. Down it goes to Jesse. Cross court. We're going to shoot the three. Kenyon is. He's going to miss it. And the ball is going to belong to Borger with 26 seconds left. 27. And foul called on. Foul called on Jaden. So it'll be two free throws for Brooks. Four fouls on Fletcher. But again, with a 27-point lead, all of this is pretty incidental.
Brooks is a good-looking athlete, isn't
he? He is. He makes the first free throw, 71-45. 15 seconds left to play between Hereford and Borger here tonight. They'll meet 3.5 weeks up in Borger. He missed this one. The rebound off to Duque. Ty is trapped in the backcourt but gets free, loses the ball. Borger gets it, throws it ahead now. Off the glass and in, 71-47. Inbounds, well, the ball's taken away by Borger again, and the buzzer sounds, and that's it. The Whitefaces win it, 71-47. And this game, well, there's some loud folks back up behind us here tonight. I don't know who. Good game, good game, good game. How much good game? Mostly just low fives. The Whitefaces get the win, though, and that's the most important thing because they are now 4-3 in the district with the second round getting underway next Tuesday night in Pampa.
Yeah, that and that's going to be an awful tough place to play. This is a tough place to play.
Yep.
Tell you.
It is a tough place to play. Trey Tolliver and Hunter Garza talking out on the floor right now. But the Whitefaces with the 24-point win. We'll take a 30-second break, let Brenda add them up for the night, and be back in 1.5 minute.
When the unthinkable happens, good neighbors show up. For 100 years, State Farm has been among the first to arrive with the latest technology and tools to help you recover faster. State Farm has been there before, and they'll be there again and again. Stop by and see your local State Farm insurance agent, Matt Silva, at 801 Main Street in Hereford. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
All right, back here at the Whiteface Gym, Hereford 24-point winner over the Bulldogs. Coach Kitten's got the totals on the night. What you got, Coacher?
I do. Nice to see Brandon Gonzalez, 14 points. 14 points,
wow,
for Loftus. 14 points for Duque. 8 points for Brylon Lopez. 7 points for Jaden Fletcher. 6 points for Zevin Gonzalez. And then 3 apiece for Nick Torres and Diego Ornelas. And 2 points, 2 free throws for DeLozier. Borger was led by Daniels with 13, followed up with 11 by number 2, Wooden.
All right, well, the girls' game was just a nail-biter that we somehow managed to win. The boys' game was a wrestling match that we won a little more easily. But
I'm telling you, I don't know when I've seen 6 technicals in a ballgame.
Me either. And all of them for something that was said. I don't know what was being said, or there's lots said that you know from time to time, but tonight apparently too much said. And
no wonder refs don't want to.
Yeah, really, really, really. All the technicals on players. So the bottom line is, though, we get the win here, and the Whitefaces go to 4-3 in the district, and that puts us kind of where where we need to be going to this second half. We've got to defend the home court, and then, boy, it'd be great if we could get a road win at West Plains or Pampa or Canyon. Canyon may be a tough ask, but the others, we've got a chance, I think. And here at home, we've got games. What have we got? Three or four games left at home.
Yeah, the guys will have four.
Three. Four?
Will they? I mean, they'll have – both have Dumas. We'll both have Randall.
Right.
Well, the guys will have three. You're right.
They have Perryton. Yep.
Yep.
So the bottom line is –
we don't have to go to Perryton again.
That was a pretty trip. It was a nice trip. Well, back on Tuesday night up on the road at Pampa. Two big games for the ladies and the men on Tuesday night.
Hey, 18 of 22, that needs to be noted, too.
That was our
free
throw.
Free throws for the game. That's
probably
a
as good. That's probably as good as we've done there.
Uh-huh. Absolutely it is.
Well, you have a good weekend, Coacher.
You
and
too, sir.
Root for the Cowboys.
I will.
Kansas City.
Adam will root for
Kansas
City. I don't be the Eagles fan from Hereford.
You are?
Adam will be.
Oh, yeah. Adam
will
be
the Eagles fan
yeah,
from
right,
Hereford.
Yeah, right. Yeah, everybody else is for the Giants. Anybody. Anybody that you know. Yeah. And then Kansas City, and who am I leaving
out?
Oh gosh! Then the and then the Bills and Cincinnati. What a what a meeting! Now there's four potentially great. Well, maybe three. I don't know about the Jaguars playing with Kansas City, but the rest of them ought to be great games.
It's okay for it to get cold this weekend, isn't it? And everybody
it is.
Can just kind of stay in.
It is.
Make some good football watching food.
All right, football watching food. I've got it. Okay.
Like you made a good pound cake tonight.
All right, Coach. We'll see you later. You guys have a great weekend. Whitefaces win them both. For all your Whiteface sports sponsors and Brenda Kitten, this is Tom Simon saying good night.
Tonight's